Houston, and the one that we had went out here in Jacksonville. Diggs, Hunter, Mixon, in. Ridley, he gone. So there's that. And lots of football talk, as always. I got a 20 questions for Dan Hicken today. I'm going to unleash on him.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, and I'll say where the subject matter came from after there's a story around it, right? And I'll tell that after the 20 questions, because if I set up the story before 20 questions, it's going to narrow down the potential answer. So, the 20 questions just leads into kind of a cool story from over the weekend. I won't say what it's related to. I don't want to. I got that daggum shot collar today, don't I?
Oh, you didn't know?
Yeah, I know. Well, that's good. That'll be fun. Got all kinds of conflicting medical diagnoses here, E. E, let me just explain one thing before we get into the grind on how this shot collar is going to be executed.
Talk to me.
I'm not afraid of the pain, bro.
Of course not. You ain't worried about it.
Yeah, no. I mean, from that or anything, if I took a punishment, you want to just, you know, stand me against the wall and shoot me with pellet guns or, you know, slap me in the daggum face, the pain don't bother me so much. Like, I would much rather be shocked just short of the electric chair than stand up here at the corner of Southside and Beach with a clown suit on. I promise you that, right? I would much rather have a painful penalty than have mayonnaise shoved up my nostrils, right? Quite frankly, I don't want to be sitting somewhere right now trying to start my second waffle to get out of some restaurant prison.
In Dodger uniform.
In Dodger poncho. Would have been nice and warm today. The poncho would have been, you know, would have been appropriate. We've got another nice, cool morning. Enjoy these mornings, man. They're going to be gone before we know them.
Would have been fitting.
And like we said before this whole thing started, if I had to choose one just based on what it would do, but now I'm reading these things about, you know, where you place them and what the potential damages can be. I'm not 28 years old, E. And I'm perfectly willing to just work through this and get this collar up. I'm going to be honest, full disclosure here. This comes against Mrs. P's objections. I don't like playing that game in life.
Oh, dear.
Of course, Mrs. P was worried I died on a one-mile run. Let's keep it all relative. Anyway, by the way, the true story should be my athletic prowess in completing the honey bun milk mile I thought it was an ultra speedy 10 minutes and 23 seconds.
Man, people was hitting me up all weekend.
They're on you, aren't they?
Yeah, they're like, oh, man, props got you, man. You know, giving you a props. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I expect it. Google's all over the city.
Listen, ain't like I did an Iron Man or did a 5-minute mile. Don't get me wrong. But
they know, you know what I'm saying? He ran it like 3 years. He just got out there and did it.
Yeah, I pride would be way too strong a word. But I do feel a little bit better about my overall health. I wonder how many 57-year-old dudes out there can step off the couch without having done anything.
And run a 10-30 mile? That's good.
That ain't bad, is it?
That ain't bad.
Okay. More than anything, I was driven by a hatred of failure in that particular instance. I know, listen, the offshoot is... my brother gets to spin the wheel in there. That'll be good for the show.
Yeah, that's later.
It's good for the brand.
Good for the brand.
So today we'll get through my payoff from my March Madness to, you know, idiocy, I guess.
Three shocks an hour.
Zip, zap, zoom.
I need about two of them.
You ain't getting none. He got them right here. We're going to set some parameters. Like I said, y'all are going to feel bad if I die right here on the air. Mrs. P, by the way, if I die, show dies, because Mrs. P going to come down and kill the two of you. No, we're not worried. I do, I just need some reinforcements from you guys on the text line. I'm not nervous about it, man. It's what everyone else is telling me. It's not me, E. You hear what I'm saying? Like in a bubble, the three of us, we throw this out there. No, we come back and day over gone. It's all the other, you know, people. Doc scared me, E. Doc scared me when we asked Doc on Thursday. He wasn't too keen on the idea. You feel me? So, I mean, if you're like, you know, if you're sitting out, God bless you. I love you. But if you're out there 24, 25, 26 and telling me you and your buddies with, you know, nine Miller Lights in, you're shocking each other with a dog collar, it's no big deal. You know, you're 24. Anyway, the collar's coming today. The honey bun milk mile could not have gone better for yours truly. I will say this, E. Buddy, my legs this weekend.
Jello.
Oh, I felt like somebody took logs and just pounded me in my quads, man. Just pounded them. Feel better today. Maybe I'll become a runner. You know, I didn't know I had such nifty speed still left in me. All right, a record-setting women's tournament fueled by Caitlin Clark. It'll be interesting to see. And I, by the way, I know the answer to this. You know, the lifespan of this women's basketball, it's beyond attention, right? It's a phenomenon. It was a Caitlin Clark phenomenon is what happened. It'll be interesting to see what the uptick, what the shelf life of this newfound popularity is once Caitlin takes her considerable skills to the next level. There is no saving the WNBA. You'll check out Caitlin Clark for a while, but the story of, you know, Iowa, little Iowa girl who goes to the state school and takes them to places they've never been and sets every single record along the way, I think it's going to register a lot more than Caitlin Clark playing for the Indiana Fever. And I know this as somebody who's been doing this for a long time. You never say never. I think the ratings, and they haven't come out yet for yesterday's final, but you probably saw, and they're uber impressive, this Caitlin Clark wave. Uber, I knew how popular she was. I've been on the Caitlin Clark train for a couple years now, right? Waiting for this kind of moment and this kind of exposure. It really began last year in the finals loss to LSU and the drama that came about that. She had this unbelievable run all year long. She set the all-time records. She got to the tournament and not only went on a run, but look who she beat on the way, man. She beat Angel Reese and LSU in the Elite Eight. Then it was UConn, and they had that terrific game on Friday night, the semifinal, that set a record all-time for viewership for a women's college basketball game. It was over 14 million. But the overall value of that win, of those ratings, was much, much, much more impressive than the highest-rated women's basketball game of all time. And I've got that breakdown of just how impressive 14.2 million viewers for Iowa-UConn was on Friday night. And it also goes to show you this lunacy of the networks of telling you can't put things on Friday night, you can't put things on in the afternoon. I think that yesterday's women's game final is going to have a higher rating than the men's final tonight. It's going to have more viewers. Well, I mean, when you consider what other events it's had more viewers than, and I'm going to run down that list a little bit later this hour. It's a remarkable one. But back to sensible programming. You know what the best time to play a championship game is in early April? 3 o'clock on Sunday afternoon, man. Not 9:20 on Monday night. It's ridiculous. I'm hoping that this women's movement can put some sanity back into the broadcast decisions for maybe some other platforms. I'm curious to see the ratings from yesterday. I'm even more curious to see the ratings from yesterday because of my belief that we should be playing big-time, high-profile sporting events in the middle of the afternoon, middle to late afternoon on the weekend, not at 9 o'clock at night. It's dumb. But the impact is real. I mean, the impact of the Caitlin Clark phenomenon is real. Mrs. P watched a basketball game from start to finish yesterday, E.T.
Oh, yeah?
Maybe the only time in her life. We were at an event on Friday night and came home. We got home in time for the second half of the UConn game. We watched that. One of the 14.2 million, I suppose, or two of the. And then, so, yeah, you looked forward to that game yesterday and watched from start to finish. I watched along. It was a fun game. The one team was a lot better than the other. Just from a pure basketball standpoint, the skill of the girls, of the ladies out, you know, on the perimeter, man, it has just shot up by leaps and bounds. We saw that with, you know, Sabrina Ionescu going toe-to-toe with Steph Curry on three-point baskets. I mean, the girls can play outside. The skill level, dribbling, handling the ball, shooting has become so much better. But it's an absolute cluster jam when they get in the lane. It's like all the skill that you see just saps out. They get in that lane. Nobody gets more than 4 inches off the ground. It's a hard watch when they get in that lane. Even the good teams, even the big girls, and South Carolina's 6'7" girl from Brazil is going to be, you know, certainly a high prospect in their pro league WNBA. But they just, from a basketball standpoint, South Carolina was just too big and too deep, man. Caitlin Clark had eight. It took 18 points for Caitlin Clark in the first half for them to have a small lead. 18. Obviously, she couldn't keep that pace. She finished with 30. South Carolina, just the much deeper, bigger team. They out-rebounded them like 54-28. You can't. I don't care what level, what league you're watching. Basketball teams get out-rebounded 54-28 do not win games.
Yep.
And that was just the whole, you know, they'd get a stop. It wouldn't matter. There'd just be some, you know, 6'7" girl arms up, you know, reaching up and grabbing the basketball. So, but it's more than the score and the kudos to South Carolina. What a run. Undefeated national champions, lost just once last year. It was to Iowa.
They didn't get them the love that, you know what I'm saying, they should have gotten because, you know, Caitlin Clark, she took over the world. But
yeah,
that South Carolina team, they went undefeated last year. They lost all their starters.
Yeah.
They lost every starter from last year, came back and went 36-0. It's very impressive.
Well, and handled it with just grace and the grace and class of a champion. It was nothing like LSU's win last year. There was no taunting, true, no stupidity. South Carolina proved you can win with some class.
Coach Mulkey and Coach Staley is two different people.
Yeah, they're way two different people. Now, they're both fiery now.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they both are fiery and can get fiery about their issues, but
one's a little more classier than the other.
For sure.
It is what it is.
Yeah, for sure.
Shout out Coach Staley.
Yeah, Coach Staley was classy in her recognition of what Caitlin Clark did. I mean, here is a coach of a team that just went undefeated and won it all, and she realizes that there were about 10 million more people watching because of who the opponent was. That's just a fact. And you look at women's you know, ratings outside of Caitlin Clark, and I mean, these are 3 and 4 and 5 times higher than what the game has ever seen consistently. And see, that's the key, consistency. And these last three games that Caitlin Clark is playing is just doom, doom, doom. A little bit more each one setting a record. They set a record for women's viewership in the, or close to, with the LSU game, and then it just ratcheted up. The big story, though, in basketball comes from the men's side. John Calipari gets the Mike White treatment and says, okay, I'll go cross-conference on you. That huge story from the college basketball landscape when we come back on the other side. Also, mock draft fatigue or not, I have a duty for you out there in listener land. They give you the percolating NFL news as it applies to the draft. Keep seeing the Jags linked to these veteran receivers that don't do much for me. If anything is done before the draft, that could certainly at least have some perhaps small impact on what the Jags draft plans are. But we got NFL news and notes when we come back on the other side. Mac Jones sat down with Jaguars.com, and so some interesting comments from what for a lot of teams would be a big name free agent addition. You go and get a guy who is, you know, been a starting quarterback for the New England Patriots. In most cases, if he signs somewhere in free agency, it's to go be somebody else's starter. But this is a chance for Mac to get his career back on track. And he talks about being back home and what kind of player the Jags are getting and more. So we will get into some of that on the other side as well. You know, I got to be honest. My dude's going to show. Oh, we got big Braves news too. I'll touch on that on the other side. Congratulations, E. You won't go 0-162. Marlins finally got a win yesterday.
Hey, we scored 10 runs, yeah, too.
Listen, you're a new baseball fan. Just dump them. Pick up a new one.
I talked about that this
week. Just
weekend.
Do it. Just revisit it. You've had them for a year. You've never followed baseball your whole life. We made you pick a team. You went with the Marlins. They were somewhat decent. Get rid of those stink fish and pick you a winner, somebody you can at least, I mean, if you're going to bandwagon, at least jump on a good one.
Think about crossing over.
I'd be okay. It's not like you're giving up your lifetime rooting interest. Find you something that's, I mean, keep it in Florida and go with the Rays.
Yeah.
I mean, at least they're competitive.
Right. and I could go to a game.
But the Braves got terrible news this weekend and then did a DNA flex. I'll explain. You're listening to The Drill. We're up and rolling. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback, divorcemenonly.com.
The Drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
The Florida Gators are on 1010XL.
The rivalry returns to the Diamond. Florida, Florida State Baseball. Tomorrow night at 6 on 1010 AM.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices, and I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Attention men and women. If you would like to get your hair back, then you need to listen to some of our clients. John in Orange Park.
IHRS showed me what was causing my hair loss and helped stop it.
Call IHRS now at 904-777-IHRS. Find out how to grow your hair back with a free hair and scalp examination. Mike from Bay Meadows.
I finally found the most experienced company who could restore my hair. Now I have hair where I had none before.
Results guaranteed. Diane from Ponte Vedra.
Now I have what lotions couldn't give me. Thick, beautiful hair.
Find out why you're losing your hair and how to grow your hair back. Call 904-777-IHRS for a limited time free hair and scalp examination.
Now my hair will grow for the rest of my life. Thanks, IHRS.
Thank you, IHRS.
Thanks, IHRS, for giving me my hair back.
Hurry, this free examination, normally $199, is yours for free and good only through Sunday. For your free examination, call IHRS at 904-777-IHRS. That's 904-777-4477. Call now.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
Men, suffering from ED or PE? You'll see instant results on your first visit at Prime Men's Medical Center. For a limited time, your initial consultation and first treatment are totally free. You'll even get a gift that enhances performance in the bedroom. Call 904-664-8217.
At Andy's Automotive and Truck Services, they know that your company's fleet is more than just a bunch of cars and trucks. It's your livelihood, your reputation, your pride. So when you need routine fleet maintenance or emergency repairs, Andy's offers after-hours and mobile service to minimize your downtime and keep your fleet running like new. While you care for your employees and customers, rest assured Andy's Automotive will take care of your fleet. Visit the team at andysats.com.
Let me get this thing unwrapped here.
Duval! Fraz, what in the world are you doing working on your Duval?
That's right, man. I really identify with Duval.
You live in St. John's County, knucklehead.
I mean the Duval sub, the Daily's Dash Duval. Turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheeses. Lettuce, tomato, crispy and fresh, you know, like me. I'm sure there's a Daily's Dash sub that sums you up.
The boss.
Because, of course,
oven roasted beef, monster cheese, roasted mushrooms, caramelized onions. It's the boss of all subs. Only available for me.
That's just not true.
What do you mean? I walked in the other day, screamed, "You know it," and said, "A boss for a boss."
Well, no matter who you are, there is a Daily's Dash sandwich or sub for you.
Go find yours. They may even make you a boss.
I'm sure they will, because it is Daily's Dash.
Where more is better.
And you got that right.
Hey, Jacksonville, I'm sure by now you've seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We are an industry leader In Solid Waste, we'd love the opportunity to earn your business. We are committed to customer service, reliability, and have unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today. GFL, green for life.
Hey, this is Stevie Beechurst of Beechurst Plumbing. Growing up in Jacksonville, I was always proud when my dad would point at a building and say, "I did the plumbing for that." That's the same kind of pride we instill in every plumber here at Beechurst Plumbing. And that's the kind of pride you can expect when you hire Beechurst Plumbing for your home or business. Right now, we're doing New Year's specials to get your project going. To find out how we can help you, visit BeechurstPlumbing.com. BeechurstPlumbing.com. Beechurst Plumbing, here to help.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket. With benefits, that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit ua234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
Northside, live local radio for Jacksonville. 1010 XL, 92.5 FM.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
It's back. The biggest jewelry sale of the year. Buy one, get one at Beard's Diamonds.
No other jewelry store in North Florida can match it. Buy any band and get the other one free.
The whole month of April.
Beard's Diamonds will beat any competitor's price.
At the St. John's Town Center.
Baloo here for Smunez Vision. Why Smunez Vision? Well, I've been with Dr. Neil Smunez now since I got back to Jacksonville in 2006. 37 years of experience he has. Smunez Vision is a family organization that focuses on personal high-quality medical and surgical eye care. Dr. Catherine Smunez is fellowship-trained in cornea and cataract surgery and all refractive surgery. Combined, that's 30 years plus in laser eye surgery. Visit SmunezVision.com today. Here you can see.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
All right, listen, if you look a big picture, it could be very easy to take what happened to the Atlanta Braves this weekend and wallow. And then the Braves had a very, I thought, very impressive DNA flex. And look, I'm going to keep this in perspective. We're 7-8 games into a 162-game season. I don't want to make too much of this. Obviously, I'm a Braves fan, so Braves fans can hear what I'm saying. If you're not a Braves fan, and E.T. in this case, can feel what I'm saying. This is what I'm a DNA guy. Yeah, I probably brought this up a bunch with you. This has been, you know, I'm a sports. It doesn't win every time. Sports DNA, when it comes down to it, the DNA of a franchise, and it can change. It takes a radical transfusion. In my lifetime, I've seen the DNA of the Braves and the Patriots in particular change more than any other franchise. And it can change the other way. I mean, that Nebraska DNA is getting weaker and weaker and weaker when it comes to the football program, huh? But I believe in DNA, man. And the Braves had a DNA flex, I thought, on Saturday. All right. Spencer Strider, their ace, led the National League, led Major League Baseball in wins and strikeouts last year. Opening day starter for Atlanta. He got banged around on Friday night. Braves ended up coming back and winning the game. But his velocity went from 99 to 94. And then you learn the terrible news on Saturday. Dude's got the elbow injury, most likely headed for Tommy John. All right. Imagine this as a baseball team. You got World Series hopes, your best pitcher. You're in week one of the season, his second start, and the future now completely up in the air. All right, so they learn that Saturday. They take the field Saturday night. Their next presumptive ace is Max Fried. And so Max Fried takes the mound on Saturday night, and for the second start in a row, can't go longer than an inning. The Braves give up 6 runs in the first. They trail 6-0. They later trailed 8-2 in like the 6th or 7th inning and came back and won the game 9-8. Man, you find out you lose Spencer Strider. You watch Max Free get banged around like nothing, like a pinata. You fall behind by 6, both 6-0 and 8-2, and you still win the game? Oof. With all that having happened to you in the last 16 hours? That's a DNA flex, man. The MLB Players Association is blaming the pitch clock for this rash of elbow injuries. I find that to be suspect, if you ask me, but it'll be an interesting question for Daniel Murphy. You know what I blame for all these elbow injuries? And by the way, I am about to Shazam spotlight you to the moon, which will at one point today cover the sun, won't it?
I see what you did there.
Yeah. Here's what I blame for this increase in elbow injuries. 93-mile-an-hour sliders and 3,000 RPM curveballs. The arm didn't suddenly change its evolutionary capabilities. Whatever we are doing to young players, whatever training they're going through when they get to the majors in 4, you've done it all wrong. You're ruining arms. But the simple fact is Nolan Ryan and others back in the day would throw 200 pitches and then pitch 4 days later and throw 6 shutout innings. And now, man, shuts you down after 80 pitches, 90 pitches, 100 pitches, 5 innings, 6 innings, 4.5. So, yeah, I'm about to read you a Shazam list of uber-talented arms that are on the shelf. And the Players Association is at least wondering, questioning if it's the pitch clock. I just don't see how, if you wait another 10 seconds to throw, that's going to make a difference. I think you're searching for answers, and the real answer is overuse as youngsters and just this lust to throw at 1,000 miles an hour. And the art of pitching has been replaced by the thunder of cannon arms. And they're just, you know, the arm can only do so much. The whole talk this offseason was about Spencer Strider developing a curveball. And now he's got an elbow injury. Have you ever played baseball? Any of you ever pitched? Any of you ever throw a curve? If you pitch and you throw a curveball, you spend the next 2 days with ice on your elbow right here because you're just whipping off that elbow, whipping it off, whipping it off, whipping it off. So I would say it would be Spencer Strider's development of a curveball, stressing his arm in ways he hadn't before in his career, led to this UCL injury, not the pitch clock. That being said, the Shazam Spotlight brought to you by ShazamAuto.com. Here is a list of notable starting pitchers right now on the injured list. The talent that is on this list right now is unbelievable. Most of them are dealing with elbow injuries. Some are either recovering from or are about to undergo Tommy John surgery. There are 7 Cy Young winners on this list, but listen to these names. Gerrit Cole, Jacob deGrom, Shohei Ohtani, Sandy Alcantara down there in Miami. Shane McClanahan, Shane Bieber, he went on the IL yesterday along with Spencer Strider. Kodai Senga, Kyle Bradish, Brandon Woodruff, Clayton Kershaw, Yuri Perez, Justin Verlander, Eduardo Rodriguez, Robbie Ray, Lance McCullers Jr., I'm skipping down the list, Dustin May, Alex Cobb, Tony Gonsolin, Ian Anderson, Spencer Strider, Walker Buehler. These are important pieces for the teams that they play on that are right now just up in the air. Short and in some cases long term for these. But, yeah, I don't think it's the pitch count. The pitch clock, rather. No, I think, like I said, it's 94-mile-an-hour sliders. It's ripping off curves with RPMs in the 3,000s. And you coaches out there playing travel ball who think you're freaking Casey Stengel, man. You coaches that take 8-year-olds to 15-year-olds all over the country and pitch them 15 innings a week. It's beyond stupid. Probably time for us to play, you know, a variety of sports. And not push every prospect into playing a professional career when it comes to the number of games. I ain't exaggerating, gang. There's 10 and 12-year-olds out there playing 100 games a year. Is that smart? So anyway, that's the Shazam Spotlight, brought to you by ShazamAuto.com. Truck guy here in the Murray Ford Superstore, Stark and Kingland. All right, I got to mention John Calipari. He got the Mike White treatment, right? Not technically fired, but it just became too much. The noise too much in Lexington. He saw Eric Musselman leave Arkansas, pick Sui, and go to USC. Some curious moves here that these coaches make. You wouldn't think that one job would be better than the other. And Calipari strikes. He's headed to Arkansas, where he will coach a team that's got a great tradition. They've got a Final Four and title-winning tradition. I imagine he will have similar success at Arkansas that he's had at Kentucky, success that has been really, really lacking for the last 5 years in particular, and really it's been 10 years since they were even in a Final Four. And it got too much. So, yeah, technically he wasn't fired, but, yeah, you can leave. And that, like Mike White, and it's definitely a lower level when it comes to expectation, makes more sense in Kentucky that just going to the tournament isn't enough. And by the way, you know, there's obviously two prongs of this. One is Calipari leaves. He goes to Arkansas. What that means, what strategy he'll employ here at this fourth or fifth career for him. I mean, from UMass to Memphis to the New Jersey Nets. Or maybe there was one in between there. Maybe he went UMass to the Nets, to Memphis, to Kentucky, and now on to Arkansas, where, look, you can win at Arkansas just the same you can at Kentucky. You can, if you're John Calipari. And I imagine this, you know, he's got six top 100 players. I imagine just about all of them say, yeah, I'm going to go to Arkansas. And if you come to Kentucky as a coach, you now have, as much or more opportunity that you would ever have as a coach. And that's why it's important for them to find the right one. It's not always the flashy one, the biggest name. Who do they turn to? It's the big names you hear now, including Billy Donovan, who, when I suggested this way back when, everyone acted like, what are you talking about? Well, this is what I'm talking about. Billy Donovan has a lot of street cred, man. Billy Donovan would be great at Kentucky. It recruits itself, dude. You're Kentucky. And so we will see. If you're a fan of a team that has a good coach, you get a little nervous. If you're Baylor, it's Scott Drew. If you're Alabama, it's Nate Oates. Would Danny Hurley leave UConn for Kentucky? If they had like $4 million a year to what you make, you'd be surprised what people would do. But just big, big impact on the college basketball landscape outside of Caitlin Clark with John Calipari yesterday stepping away from Kentucky, going to move on to Arkansas. And that leaves an opening at Kentucky, which will be fun to follow as well. You know, Mac Jones initially committed to the University of Kentucky out of Bowles. Mac didn't look like he was the level of player coming out of high school that was going to be a star in, you know, Power Five, a national title contender, but it's exactly what it ended up being at the University of Alabama. Went on to be a first-round draft pick, a fantastic star, a playoff quarterback as a rookie for the Patriots, and it just kind of got progressively worse for him in New England. Well, he sat down with Jaguars.com and talked about his move from New England to Jacksonville, and first and foremost, what it feels like to be back in the hometown.
Feels amazing. First of all, the weather. that's definitely something I'm excited about, but just to be back here in the community I grew up in, it's just every kid's dream, and I'm just excited to get to work.
All right, it was pretty well established what Mac's role was here, right? The team made that clear. You could tell from the press conference. It's not like there may be some implication day to day in pushing Trevor and, you know, working with him, but it seemed pretty established, right? He's coming in to improve the backup quarterback position for the Jaguars, and Mac explains the best that he can what kind of player the Jags are getting.
Honestly, just a guy who loves football, and I'm excited to be here and get back on track and in my hometown. It's just a great opportunity for me, but I'm going to give it everything I got, and I'm excited to work with the quarterbacks and just learn from everybody and bring my personality to the room.
All right, so that's a little bit from one of the free agent signees this offseason. We got more on a football fix. A name that you see mocked to the Jaguars, not in round one, but potentially in round two or round three if he would happen to fall, is going to see his draft status plummet. We'll explain when we return. You're listening to The Drill. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback. DivorceMenOnly.com.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
This is Brian Musburger's VSiN Action Update on 1010XL, brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning. When you're stuck, call the Duck. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
UConn laying 7 against Purdue in the NCAA Championship game at State Farm Stadium in Glendale, Arizona today. Prop bet on the board, first to 15, UConn minus 170, Purdue plus 135. Scotty Scheffler, 4-1 with the Masters at Augusta National. Rory McIlroy, 10-1. John Rahm, 12-1. And Xander Schauffele, 18-1. Tampa Bay Rays, another 42 road favorite of the LA Angels today, plus 120. 8.5 under at Angels Stadium in Anaheim. It's the Atlanta Braves, the 2018 home favorite against the New York Mets, plus 180. 9.5 under at Truist Park. Free betting splits available at vsin.com/splits. With your action update, Mike Sennett, 1010XL.
Duck Duck Rooter is a full-service plumbing company that's locally owned and operated, fully licensed and insured. We'll be at your home in a timely manner, provide honest pricing, and ensure the job is completed correctly, or we'll make it right. Duck Duck Rooter can handle all plumbing jobs, including repairing broken pipes, clearing clogged drains, to installing new fixtures, water heaters, garbage disposals, and full repipes for older homes. If you're stuck, call the Duck, 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
Packer here with another unbelievable stat. I'm now down 45 pounds in just 6 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. 45 pounds, and I basically just started the program. I wasn't always this walking advertisement for feeling good. Let's just say the struggle was real. Tried everything, programs, diets, and yes, even those injections. Sure, I lost a few pounds, but the results were so slow. Top that with not feeling myself, coupled with needing shots for the rest of my life, no thanks. Thank you. It's not just the 45-pound number. Even though, yeah, that's unbelievable. It's about life, man. I took Little Hack to SeaWorld last week. Walked around all day, no sweat, no being tired. 2 months ago, I would have skipped out on that whole experience. If it's time for you to drop some weight like it was for me, do what I did. Go to awaken180weightloss.com or call 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800. It's Awaken 180 Weight Loss.
Break free from the old-school hassle at All-Pro Roofing. They've revolutionized the game. And guess what? No more pressure, hassle, or time meeting with someone face-to-face for a roof quote. Unlock the power of an instant roof quote right from the comfort of your home. Get the information you need when you need it. Explore your roofing options today. Head over to allproroofingllc.com. Hit that instant roof quote tab for a free instant roof quote. Allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132706.
CDC 060138.
A lot of companies will tell you they're the best. At Custom Tree Surgeons, they show you every time. Custom Tree Surgeons has built an all-pro team. Every tree service professional has years of experience, continually trained and certified. They know what, when, and how to handle any job. It gets done efficiently and quickly by a team of experts. So for tree trimming, removal, stump grinding, and emergency services, forget any name other than Custom Tree Surgeons. There is no job they can't do better. Go to website, CustomTreeSurgeons.com. That's CustomTreeSurgeons.com. And let them show you how the job is supposed to get done.
Our slogan, Know Before You Blow, applies to more than just DUI cases. Hi, I'm attorney Lee Lockett of Lockett Law. Battery charges can result in jail time and criminal convictions too. So know before you blow a gasket and hit a loved one or a stranger. Drug crimes like possession of marijuana and cocaine will land you in cuffs too. So know before you blow. In a boating under the influence case, you also have the option to blow or not to blow. So know your options. Know before you blow. Go to knowbeforeyoublow.com now. Offices Jacksonville.
Mike Dempsey, 10 to noon weekdays on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Dave Binion here with my son Ammon, who is the air duct cleaning manager at Zero Res. So Ammon, you may notice a little rattle in my voice and some puffiness in my eyes. That's because allergy season is coming on. Can Zero Res help?
Yes, your health has a lot to do with the air you breathe. A clean and healthy home begins with clean air. At Zero Res, we can help clean the air in your home by cleaning your air ducts, cleaning the coils in your HVAC units, and fogging the system with a powerful antimicrobial that helps kill and control the growth of microorganisms in your air. We also have options for maintaining your clean air with our excellent inline air purifier and UV lights that will help keep your system clean and healthy. At Zero Res, we are more than just air duct cleaners. We're a clean air specialist.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean.
Z-E-R-O-R-E-C. Zero Res.
I'm here with Danny Van Sickle, director of the Electrical Training Alliance. Danny, tell me about your program.
Hey, Rick. We're a five-year electrical apprenticeship. Our students start out making over $40,000 a year, and right now graduate making over $90,000 a year, including benefits. There is no tuition or no student debt. You just have to apply and get accepted.
Did you say no tuition and no student debt?
You heard that right, Rick. Once you're accepted to the program, your only costs are the books and the course fees, about $800 a year.
That sounds like an amazing opportunity. How can I learn more?
Just go to etajax.org, and you can apply there.
Apply by May 23rd.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit republicservices.com.
Equal opportunity. Employer.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
All right, we're back. So the LSU game with Angel Reese and Caitlin Clark got... what, like 9.5 million, remember? And wow, it was just huge. It was an increase over the matchup from a year ago. And then UConn, Iowa outdid that on Friday night, set an all-time record for women's basketball TV ratings. They got 14.2 million. Now, where does that rank? 14.2 million viewers. All right, so the 14.2 million for Iowa-UConn women's basketball averaged more viewers than any women's college basketball game ever, more than every 2023 NBA Finals game, more than every 2023 World Series game, more viewers than the 2023 Orange Bowl or the Big Ten Championship, more than the Cotton Bowl, the Pac-12, the Big 12 Championship, more than the ACC Championship, more than the Peach Bowl, more than the final round of the Masters, more than the Daytona 500, more viewers than the Indianapolis 500, more viewers than every tennis Grand Slam final, men's and women's, and more than every 2023 college football regular season game except one. That's the Caitlin bounce. And I would imagine the basement will be lifted. You know, the interest in the women's game, is it going to be carried on, you know, with just faceless games between Indiana and, you know, Tennessee? I don't know. I think you probably have to kind of have a phenomenon, really. But maybe the ceiling, the basement gets, like, you know, the rating for that other Friday game was like a 7, you know, which is an awful lot for a women's basket. It's more than some World Series games in and of itself. It'd be interesting to see what the actual rating is on the final yesterday, and I will contend an argument that I've always made. Playing yesterday at 3 in the afternoon is going to give it a much higher rating than if they had played it at 8:30 last night. Of course, we'll never know. We'll just see what yesterday's afternoon rating was. Fire up the band, E. We got a football fix. Let me get some news and notes here real quick. Let's start with a prospect who you see linked to Jacksonville, not in round one, but down in round two, sometimes even round three, viewed as one of the top three or four defensive tackles in the rookie draft. His name is Devondre Sweat, and he was arrested on a DWI charge, a big man projected to be an early round pick. will now see his draft status certainly affected. The 22-year-old detained in Austin, Texas, overnight Saturday night. Misdemeanor charge of driving while intoxicated. All right, so I don't know if you caught this, but Tyreek Hill basically confirmed that the Dolphins had signed or will be signing Odell Beckham Jr., which is news to Odell Beckham Jr. Hill posted a photo of him and OBJ on Snapchat saying, OBJ to Miami confirmed. Beckham, wondering why he's hearing about such things, he took to X. I'm confused today. Did I sign somewhere? We'll see, man. We think about all this interest and how OBJ always gets interest. And here he's sitting here, dude. They've snatched up 40 receivers in the free agent market, it seems like. Maybe that overall interest is starting to wane just a little bit. The Patriots have signed Kyle Duggar, a safety, to a four-year deal over the weekend. Panthers extend Derrick Brown. Derrick Brown's a guy I can remember us talking about around here. I think the year that we were looking at Derrick Brown, he went ahead of where the Jaguars would have picked, but he's been a good player for the Panthers. Gets a four-year, $96 million extension. And mock drafts are heating up, firing off at every, you know, twist and turn. And we'll keep you updated on this as we move along. That's Football Fix. You're welcome. Brought to you by the Jacksonville Sharks. Oof, off to a disappointing 0-3 start. We'll talk to Jason Gibson a little bit later today. And by the home course, the Julenton Creek Golf Club. The best value in golf. Tee it high and let it fly. At the home course, the Julenton Creek Golf Club. Hick and Arrival, more come your way next. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback on The Drill.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. You love him.
A friend.
You hate him.
I guess irony can be pretty ironic sometimes.
You love to hate him and hate to love him.
That's not possible.
It is with this. Ryan the Hacker Green.
Starting to get the picture?
Right after Rick Ballew. Evenings on 1010XL.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Sheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. 904-274-5522.
Hey, when it comes to insurance, folks like us think like this. Man, we pay a lot of money monthly, so those premiums, so if something happens and we need you to be there. That's exactly what the Kaproskis do. Craig and Chris take care of our insurance needs. And when I say take care, I mean it. If something happens, you call the Kaproskis. If they don't answer, they call you right back. It's called customer service, and it's something that Kaproskis do not take lightly. So if you need homeowners, auto, flood, boat insurance, small business, Kaproskis are always there for you at your time of need. And how do I know this? Because they've helped me and my family numerous times. Me, my son, my daughter, my wife. Get an insurance checkup today. It's easy to get a hold of Craig.Kaproski at goosehead.com. That's Craig.Kaproski, K-O-P-R-O-S-K-I, goosehead.com, or call 478-8422, 478-8422. Craig and Chris Kaproski are part of the Goosehead Insurance family, part of our family as well.
People ask me all the time, Mia, why buy from Arlington Toyota? And when they do, here's what I tell them. Let's start with peace of mind. When you buy any new Toyota from Arlington, their lifetime warranty goes with you. That's unlimited time and miles. Plus, you get 30 days to love your pre-owned purchase or exchange it for one that you do. And you even get a complimentary car wash with your service visit. Now you know why you should buy from Arlington. 10939 Atlantic Boulevard and online at arlingtontoyota.com.
Hey, this is Stevie Beechurst of Beechurst Plumbing.
Growing up in Jacksonville, I was always proud when my dad would point at a building and say, "I did the plumbing for that." That's the same kind of pride we instill in every plumber here at Beechurst Plumbing. And that's the kind of pride you can expect when you hire Beechurst Plumbing for your home or business. Right now, we're doing New Year's specials to get your project going. To find out how we can help you, visit BeechurstPlumbing.com. BETROSPlumbing.com. Beechurst Plumbing, here to help.
The flagship station of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement. Plus, no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
DivorceMenOnly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to DivorceMenOnly.com. DivorceMenOnly.com. Offices, Jacksonville.
Have you tried golfing at the improved Cimarron Golf Club? If you haven't, tell you what, you're missing out on the best deal in Jacksonville. Now, many of you have received a postcard in the mail, and of course, if you bring that with you, $45 plus tax to play. That includes a cart, lunch, and a beer at the brand new Stone Barrel Tap House. Now, go to the website, that is CimarronGolfClub.com, and sign up for the Wild One Loyalty Program. That's the Wild One Loyalty Program, and get all of these specials emailed to you from Cimarron.
Catch Gators baseball all season long on 1010XL. Brought to you by Farrah and Farrah, the official personal injury law firm of the Jaguars. And Renewal by Anderson, the official window and door replacement partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, sponsored by Southern Oak Insurance. Gator football head coach Billy Napier found his defense to be on point for the second scrimmage.
I would compliment the defense today. I thought that we tackled extremely well.
Number 6 Florida baseball was outlasted by Missouri in the series finale on Sunday afternoon. 4 Gators homered in the game, which saw the Tigers strike first in the finale, putting a 4 spot on the Gators in the bottom of the first. Florida remains on the road with a Tuesday visit to Florida State. Game time is 7 p.m. On the women's side of the NCAA basketball tournament, the South Carolina Gamecocks helped keep the championship in the SEC following LSU's win last year. Dawn Staley, head coach of South Carolina, team provided an undefeated season.
They are incredible human beings and young people who trusted ultimately become champions.
That's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Sam Nelson.
At 7:04, it's 55 degrees. Your time and your temp is brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Ladies and gents, please put your hands together as Dan Hicken enters the studio.
the potentialities
yes, sir.
Ratchets up, and what will be accepted becomes a higher and higher floor. So,
what my dog yeah, Bone Crusher said?
Well, no, it's just a matter of do I want you to eat the tarantula or just let it crawl on you? Like that's where we're that's where we're floating around.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. All right.
Great.
If you think it's going to be drink a bottle of hen, you're wrong.
I ain't worried about that. Let's get past the day first.
What a weekend in sports, man. All kinds of stuff happening, man. There's good stuff everywhere. Then we get a shocker last night. Cal's going to Arkansas.
Got the Mike White treatment, didn't he? It's like Mike White, like another level up.
I haven't been able to rouse Kentucky Jeff and get any comments yet.
That's what they wanted.
Slim, I don't know. They got to be dancing in the streets. They're gonna chase Danny Hurley. They're gonna ask Jay Wright. They're gonna look at these guys. Well, you know, it all started because SMU fired their coach. And then the USC coach went to SMU.
Every one of these moves seemed like it was
Arkansas
a down.
Arkansas coach went to LA. And now Cal goes to Arkansas.
I think this speaks to inter-office turmoil. Every one of these moves is a slight down move.
Yeah,
move from USC to Southern Miss or to SMU. It's a down move to me from Arkansas to USC, and now it's a down move from Kentucky to Arkansas. I will say this, Arkansas, and I don't know about tournament success, Arkansas will win more games while Calipari is there than Kentucky wins while Calipari is at Arkansas. You're just in a catch-22. That's a hard one. We talked a bunch about it, and now it's come to fruition.
Well,
I get it.
I think this is kind of a win-win, to be honest with you. I think Kentucky had enough of Cal.
He gets a good job.
They get off the hook with the millions that they – I mean, look, Arkansas has – what Arkansas does have is they got that dude Tyson Chicken,
yeah.
Who's probably stroked that $35 million up to Lexington and said, see ya.
Yeah. Can he win in the tournament? Can he win with freshmen?
Yeah.
There was only one freshman starter in the Final Four. I heard that stat. That's amazing.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. So anyway, it's huge news on the eve of the national championship game and takes a lot away from everything that's happened. But it was just such big news. You got that. In a weird April day, man, you got all kinds of crazy stuff happening yesterday. We had a heck of a golf finish. I mean, a shootout there with Akshay Bhatia and Denny McCarthy going back and forth. McCarthy shoots a dadgum 28 on the back nine, and then from 100 yards in sudden death, pitches it in the creek. I mean, that's not a good shot, my man. Oof. So, anyway, and then I got Bhatia with his shoulder thing. I got a timeout on the – who gets a timeout on the PGA Tour? Should you be to get taped up? Just hit the ball on the green and you've won the tournament, my man.
It was just so soft. And why would you want to do that if you're him?
Yeah. Let me hit it up here, and then we can take a look.
What a story, though, this kid is, huh?
Yeah.
I first saw him on one of the YouTube channels, Hick, like a year ago. It's been a fast ride.
Right next to me on the range with Corn Ferry. He won that tournament.
Yeah. Oh, he won the one you were at?
He was right there. And I'm like, who is this guy? Because he is skinny.
Skinny, yeah.
Gosh, dog, he's a skinny dude. But he hits it a ton. So anyway, that was kind of cool. And the shout out, by the way, shout out to a little St. Augustine girl. She won her bracket in the drive chip and putt up at Augusta. I think she's the first local to win.
10, 11-year-old, yeah.
Yeah, kind of neat. Lily Wachter was her name. So anyway, cool for her. FSU girl won the Augusta Women's National Amateur, an FSU golfer. So it's Masters Week. Baseball's in full bloom. You guys got devastating news on Friday or Saturday.
Yeah,
I don't know what day it was. That's
the problem. The problem with that news for Atlanta is this: over 162. I mean, they're still going to be a playoff team. They got enough to do
playoffs.
That. But when your goal inside and outside the franchise, fan base, and otherwise is to win the World Series, and you get back to a point that's really the only thing that's going to make you feel fulfilled at the end.
Mm-hmm.
What it does now, though, and the World Series is still winnable, but there's a big if, Dan. If Fried, Morton, and Sale are healthy, you're talking about three injury-prone dudes. The odds of that happening aren't good. They've got a lot of young arms that over the course, last year, Dan, they like dang near set a record for starters in a year. They had like 21 starters or 18 starters, something stupid, in 100-something games. So I don't think it's necessarily going to kill them in the regular season. Not going to kill their season, but man, yeah. I'm not buying for a second, though, this pitch clock nonsense. Come on.
No, No, it's
It's 94 mile an hour sliders and 3,000 RPM curveballs. You know, it's not a coincidence that Spencer Strider, quote, developed a curveball this offseason and now his elbow's shot.
I would go with what Dr. James Andrews said. I started following injury patterns and injury rates in the year 2000. In those days, I did about 8 or 9 Tommy Johns per year in high school, age and younger. A large majority of Tommy Johns were at the major league level, then the minor league level, then the college level, just a handful of high school kids. In today's situation, the whole thing is flip-flopped. The largest number is youth baseball. They've surpassed what's being done in the major leagues. It's a terrible situation. Andrew says the obsession with velocity and spin at the youth level is having a devastating impact on arms in the game itself.
Why is he?
These kids are throwing 90 miles an hour their junior year of high school. The ligament itself can't withstand that kind of force. We've learned in our research lab that baseball is a developmental sport. Tommy John ligament matures at about age 26.
So why?
In high school, the red line where the forces go beyond the tensile properties of the ligament is about 80 miles an hour. It's cut and dried. It's the system. It's too much. There should be no listen, again, take it for what it's worth. You guys, if you enjoy it, whatever, I would not let – your kid shouldn't play fall baseball. Shouldn't be any fall baseball. Shouldn't be. Should play. You can play. Start up. You can crank it up in January. Start your games in February. You want to play in the summer? That's fine. End of July, you're done. You're done. August, September, October, November, December, you're off. Go play another sport. Go do something else. If you're young, it's
their fault. It's these coaches who are uninformed,
well,
taking kids.
No,
to play. It is 100 games a year, Dan. We've
not
all
just
been
that.
There.
It's not
We've
just that. There. It's also. It's that's part of it, but it's also college coaches. It's college coaches telling a kid, hey, come on up. And you know that if you want to pitch at that level, you got to be busted 90, and you haven't pitched in 2 weeks. And so you're throwing as hard as you possibly can to get ready for it, and your arm's not ready. You haven't built it back up. It's these showcases in the fall where all the college coaches are going to be there, and then three show up. I mean, there's such a ridiculousness. The system sucks. It's what we have. No one has fixed it. No one has had the gumption to go in and say, hey, listen, this is how it's got to be. And Murphy will tell you. He'll come. We'll ask Daniel when he comes in this week, obviously, and talk about it a great deal. But it's the youth. It's the youth. You can, like, Tyler Glasnow had a good point about the when they outlawed the sticky stuff. I mean, Murph himself told me it was okay for these guys, the sticky stuff, because they don't want to get hit in the head.
Yeah, control the ball.
And Glasnow said, look, I only used sunscreen and rosin mixed together. I'm not looking for any advantage. I just want to be able to hold the baseball. I changed the way I threw it. I had to change my grips. I got hurt. So that's an interesting theory. The pitch clock, I don't see, but I'm willing to listen. But it's also – it's not like all of a sudden it just happened. This has been going on for years. I don't know why the Spencer Strider one triggered it. I mean, DeGrom, I mean, go down the list here of guys who have been getting hurt over the years.
I have Hick, this is a list of guys right now on the injured list with elbow injuries, most of them.
Yeah.
Garrett Cole, Jacob DeGrom, Shohei Ohtani, Sandy Alcantara, Shane McClanahan, Shane Bieber, Spencer Strider, Kadai Singa, Brandon Woodruff, Clayton Kershaw, Yuri Perez, Justin Verlander, Robbie Ray. These are Lance McCullers. These are frontline, 20-win potential pitchers.
Right. There's no question. There's no question it's out of control, and somebody needs to fix it. I don't know who's going to fix it. Maybe Major League Baseball could take charge. I don't know. But I think the number one thing right now for me would be, you know what? We're not playing fall baseball.
Well, the interesting
no
thing,
more fall baseball.
That's what I mean. It's
you guys
the players
are done.
And coaches are
at
doing
the end of
much.
July, have a good rest of your summer. Enjoy the fall. Go lift weights. Go hit. Go play football. Go play basketball. Go do something else or work on your game, whatever. But there's not going to be fall baseball games where you're asked or showcases. There should be no showcases where a kid hasn't thrown for 6 weeks and then all of a sudden he's got to ask to, because it's all – everything is based on velocity and pitching nowadays. There's – and we've talked about this numerous times. You wonder – if a Greg Maddux could have even made it through the minor league system. Obviously, someone like that is an aberration, and you think he would, but there are guys who can pitch and who can throw 87, 88 and pitch at a high level. I'm not saying the major leagues, but
The interesting thing is, Dan, they throw so hard, and look, the batters are hitting it as best, good as ever.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this throwing 99 is not an advantage.
No.
It's really not.
You gotta learn to pitch.
Nobody's overpowering any major league batter. Strider's the closest.
Yeah, but you gotta learn, and it's a shame, and we'll see what happens. There's so much millions of dollars tied into all these leagues and these summer teams and such. Nothing's gonna change.
Well, the problem is this: parents don't know. Too many parents now.
Yeah, they sit there and blame the parents. Parents don't know.
Yeah, parents don't know.
We trust coaches and people. Oh yeah, we'll get them to this, we'll get them that. You don't know. It's the first time you've gone through it with a kid, so who knows?
But this is the reality is this:
mm-hmm.
10 to 16-year-old kids, sometimes younger than 10,
mm-hmm.
should not be playing professional length schedules. Some of these kids play 100 games a year. Hick, you know this.
Oh yeah, 100%.
100 games a year 100%. Is beyond ridiculous for your child, just for their well-roundedness. Mm-hmm. I mean, other things have to suffer if you're playing that much baseball. It's dumb.
It's too much.
It's a hobby. It's a sport. It's fun time. It's not a career path when you're 8.
No. Especially before you mature. I mean, once you haven't even hit puberty. You hit puberty and you go to the big field and everything changes. So there's a lot going on in that world. We can discuss that forever. That's a whole show in itself. Our Dreamfinders Homes poll question of the day. Dreamfinders Homes, the official home builder of the PGA Tour, the Gators, and the Jags. 20-plus Jacksonville communities in the best locations. 2 weeks away from the draft, I want the Jags to trade up for a wide receiver, trade back for extras, draft a wide receiver at 17, or draft a cornerback at 17. Those are your four choices. Likely scenarios. I don't know how likely trading up is. You need partners to trade up or back. Draft a wide receiver at 17, draft cornerback at 17. Like, I'll give you an example. While I would probably choose trade up for a wide receiver, I would not draft wide receiver at 17. If I stay at 17, I would draft corner or something else because I know there are enough wide receivers in round twos and threes that I can get another wide receiver. So I don't think I'm still going to get a true number one wide receiver at 17. So that's how I feel, but we'll let you guess. We have about 400 votes at Dan Hick and Eel added on social. Trade up for a wide receiver, trade back for extras, draft a wide receiver at 17, draft a cornerback at 17. Right now, what would you do?
I think I'm really leaning toward drafting receiver at 17.
Okay. E, what would you do? Trade up, trade back, draft a wide receiver, or draft a corner?
Trade up.
Okay. You're in the lead, E, with 38.1%. 32.2%, however, say draft corner at 17. 17% say draft wide receiver. 12.6% only want to trade back for extras. Dreamfinders Homes, quality built homes you can call your own. Visit dreamfindershomes.com to find your home. And right now, for a limited time on select move-in ready homes, Dreamfinders offering an amazing 3.99% interest rate in year one of your mortgage. Go to dreamfindershomes.com for more details. Again, you can vote throughout the morning. We'll give you the results at the end of the program, which we got a lot going on today. We got Freddie T joining us, I believe. Is that correct, everybody?
That's correct.
All right, so we'll talk to him as now we're getting closer to the draft, and we'll start naming some names and situations and see how he thinks and what he thinks is going to happen as well. He kind of
told us last week, you know, receivers where he would lean.
Yeah. We were in the final week of the National Hockey League. So, man.
Your team's going to win that trophy you didn't want.
Yeah, that looks like it, but that's okay. They're really good. They're setting franchise records for victories and points in a season, and I've been on them all year. I've told you that back in the beginning. I thought they could have something there, so I'm going to ride or die with these guys because my baseball club's not going to give me much. We got Mets Braves showdown already. Game one tonight.
Oh,
we got Julio Teheran. You'll have to deal with. Okay, the revenge factor.
Yeah.
Julio marches into the ACL.
We faced him again with someone in an American League team. But I woke up one day last summer and there's Julio Teheran facing us. He actually pitched pretty good.
So Julio, me and Julio down by the ATL tonight. So we'll see how that rolls. A lot of other baseball news and notes coming your way as well, plus always talking about the National Football League. We're just warming up on a Monday is what we're doing.
Sure. And we have I don't know what the delay. What's the deal with the shock device in there?
Oh, well,
it's going to be tomorrow?
Okay.
Is it put together?
Oh, that thing put together.
Oh, it is? Oh, is it?
It's ready? Together.
All right, so you're going to have to make a decision on the shock
collar. Yeah, I was going to. I mean, there's no decision. I got to get shocked. Oh. Sucks.
All right.
I mean, what decision?
No decision then.
Yeah, I mean, okay. I don't know. Is there a decision? Should we do something? I mean, I don't know what to say. I've told you exactly where I am on this whole thing. It's against objection. It's over objection. Anytime you're over objections of the missus, it's the only thing that makes you concerned. But I know you're. I'm not putting this on you.
Yeah, that's your.
I'm not putting this on anyone, bro. Yeah. We'll fire it up. Let's go. It's a Monday morning quarterback. For Pete's sake, man. I've already got to get punished. I'm getting. It isn't me. Y'all put it on there. I accept it. Middle fingers for both of you. And that wheel for you, my friend, is going to have blood dripping from it when I'm done. Blood.
Who can?
The drill. The drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
Is your AC system showing signs of wear and tear? Get ahead of your AC system replacement before the summer with JTM Comfort Services. Nothing worse than coming home on a hot summer afternoon to find your AC stopped working. Right now, get a special rebate on the purchase and installation of an 18 to 20 SEER Bosch heat pump system. Financing now available on qualified repairs and replacements.
Your comfort is our name. Call my dad to keep you in the game.
Hey, you know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Hickin here, gang. It's time to spring into action and refresh your vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. From dry eyes and allergies, causing irritation to cataracts blurring your vision, Bowden Eye can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit BowdenEye.com to schedule your consultation. Bowden Eye and Associates, we're keeping the First Coast focused.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Awaken 180 Weight Loss. Look, last week I recognized I had made a difference. No, it wasn't saving a puppy from a well or pulling an old lady out of a burning building. Remarkable as those would have been, this one was pretty cool as well. I saw a hacker and he was down 45 pounds thanks to Awaken 180, and it was awesome. Well, why was it awesome? Well, he thanked me for introducing him to Awaken 180. So I'm not only able to watch him have that same transformation that I had, but I know I had a bit part in helping someone make a 180 with their life, and it inspired me to continue sharing mine. From Matt Hayes to Hacker and hundreds of listeners, every story is uniquely inspiring. If you have questions, feel free to ask me about Awaken 180. I'm happy to answer all of them, and just maybe you will be the next Awaken 180 success story. Call Awaken 180 today at 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or schedule your consultation online at awaken180weightloss.com.
Exciting news from All Pro Roofing. Effective right now, you can get an instant roof quote. Just click the instant roof quote tab on their website. Whether you're in need of roofing, exterior siding, or windows, All Pro Roofing is your local partner for quality craftsmanship. Click the instant roof tab and voila, get an instant quote. It's that simple. Click on the instant roof quote tab today at allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132706.
CDC 060138. Tired of changing out bad sod year after year? Get it done right with Roundtree Sod. Big or small, they have it, and always supplied farm fresh. For a lush, legendary green lawn, call 7414-SOD for a free estimate. 7414-SOD.
Jacksonville Jaguars, 1010XL, 92.5 FM.
There's something that binds us all. The constant hunger to improve. The obsession with every detail and the reward of a custom fitting taking your game to a whole new level. We're all bound by two words said by golfers worldwide. Schedule your fitting at Edwin Watts Golf Shops. Find your local store at worldwidegolf.com. Get there.
Transmission troubles? I'm Robin Sidbury, owner of Action Transmission Specialist on Merrill Road. So come in and see how we can help solve your transmission troubles. We service all makes and models. Remember, get traction. Call Action at 744-0755.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Folks, the First Coast has voted. Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute is proud to be chosen as Bold City's best in four categories: best orthopedic practice, physical therapy, pain management, and foot care clinic. For the last 30 years, JOI has continually strived for the highest level of orthopedic surgery and rehab care. As the needs of the community evolve, so will they. That's why coaches, parents, and athletes choose JOI. Call them at JOI 2000 or visit joi.net. JOI, where the pros go.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Now, the 10-minute drill.
This is a big one.
On 1010XL.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Hit it.
All right, we got sports concepts and rationalizations coming your way. At the end of the drill, we have some razzle dazzle. That's capital R, capital D. What are we handing out today, E?
Oh, today we giving out a
shock collar.
We giving out floral arrangements to coon flowers. Excuse me, mm-hmm. But also the winner will be entered for a chance to play in this year's Guggen Golf Classic.
All right, so
and that drawing is April 10th.
Coon flowers coming your way. Prosser's got the shock collar.
He just did it. He just did one.
I thought it was off.
He thought it was off. Well, that's one.
He just shot.
Why does he get to do it?
I was in the bracket challenge.
I thought you were doing it.
I'll let him do it. I don't want to do it. I'm not dealing with all this nonsense.
I don't want to do it. In some way, that's made you more admirable to me. I don't know
away.
If I'm misreading that. Perhaps I am.
But I just tapped it.
The fact that he can't do it. Yeah, that's one. You don't
yes,
just.
I know it's one.
Damn.
You got to hold that thing down, E.
I know. I ain't going to do my dog prize like that.
What's the number on E?
Three.
Three's fine.
You can bump it up one.
Oh. Bump it up to four.
You can bump it up. Because where I put it. I'm not, listen, y'all, and by the way, you text line tough guys, you can come all damn day long. You YouTube wonder kids, come all day long. I'm not putting a dog shot collar on my neck right next to my dad's spine.
Man,
I'm not
no.
doing it. Y'all can, y'all have a party tonight, invite your friends over, and y'all, you know, do shots and watch the game and shock each other in the brain if you want. It's starting here on the thigh. We're going to move it around. Ooh, it's feeling, though, like.
Hey, yeah. Behave yourself over there. You'll get another one.
He got me right out the gates, man.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't. Why did I tell him to turn it back down to what it was? By the way, what am I doing?
Oh no.
Yeah, and what am I saying?
Stop. Right, look, back to three.
Yeah, Yoda looked at me like, "What? I had two was enough. No, three's, right? Yeah, three's good."
All Yoda right. experimented.
That's
with it.
That's one. I got two more this hour, and then oh my goodness.
Well, we got a lot going on in sports. John Rahm has called for LIV Golf to move the traditional 72-hole tournament format. As the two circuits continue to compete against each other.
That makes it, listen to me, much of my distaste of the LIV was them trying to rebrand golf and what was acceptable at the highest level of competition. And 54-hole shotgun start, short-wearing, you know, mixers is not. That's not it. So, you know, good. If they get there, good.
This week, the LIV guys and the tour guys and everybody gets together again with the Masters, so that'll be fun to see what happens. Can a LIV guy win the Masters? Now that we've had a year of playing exhibition golf, can they ramp it up? They're talented enough, obviously. John Rahm, Cam Smith are guys who could win. It'll be interesting to see how they perform, though. And if they don't perform well, then the topic will continue to come up, even though a live guy has already won a major, Brooks Koepka. So, and maybe he's in good form. We shall see what happens going forward. That should be interesting. All right, we got national championship game tonight. UConn, the final four games were not great, quite frankly. Purdue was in control the whole way.
The two best teams. It's kind of like we
Bama tried to hang with UConn. Didn't happen. So we go from there. South Carolina beat Iowa fairly easily. South Carolina is too big.
They out-rebounded like 54-28.
Yeah, they could not.
They're deeper. Their bench was bigger. They're just better. You can see why they're undefeated. Having not watched them all year long, you can see why they're undefeated. And, yeah, that was a
The big story in college basketball is John Calipari is jumping ship going to Arkansas, for goodness sakes. Yeah. That's a stunner there.
Who will win more games while Calipari is at Arkansas? Arkansas or Kentucky?
I don't well, who will go farther in tournament?
Well, that's one thing at a time here.
Yeah. Kentucky. Kentucky's Kentucky.
Kentucky will Kentucky win more games. But doesn't Arkansas win on pace with Kentucky as is? I mean, Arkansas is the one that's been to the Elite Eight twice
Arkansas
in the last.
Arkansas ain't Kentucky. Kentucky is.
I think when they are rolling, I think Arkansas with the dynamic coach is better than Kentucky with an average one. I mean, Arkansas was better than Kentucky or as good when Nolan Richardson was going head-to-head with Rick Pitino. I mean, the Hogs went to back-to-backs, didn't they? They won one. So,
That's a long time ago.
Well, I think Arkansas has that ceiling. Arkansas has been to the Elite Eight twice in, I think, the last 4 years. So they're kind of rolling a little bit at the time. But there's a reason Musselman left, right? You get to a program, there's something that's not right for you to go take another job.
Yeah, I
have a little more respect maybe for Arkansas than you do.
You're talking. I'm just looking here. Mike Anderson, John Pelfrey, Stan Heath. You got to go back and you bring up Nolan Richardson. Well, Nolan Richardson was
those other guys had their moments.
Yeah,
that's fair. That's 30 years.
I mean, it's
well, what's Kentucky done since Pitino and Tubby left in '98?
Cal won one.
One, but I mean, that's the same amount of time. I guess is my point.
Yeah,
I don't know. I think Arkansas with Calipari can. I mean, he took Memphis to the championship game. He's going to win at Arkansas.
He'll win, yeah. But I don't.
I think Kentucky.
Arkansas ain't Kentucky.
Well, Kentucky That's ain't Kentucky. Saying. Not anymore. The game's changed. It's all changed. These powers aren't. Where was
North Carolina, Duke, Kentucky, Kansas? They're all. What has changed about those guys? Kansas just won one recently. Carolina was in the championship game recently. And was disappointed to exit early this year. Duke is one win away from the Final Four, and they got the best player in high school basketball coming in. I don't think it's changed that much. I mean, I know the game has changed, the silliness of the game, but I don't know. I think Kentucky will be fine. Now, if they get the wrong guy, then they're in yes, that would be a problem. I think they got to get the right guy, and I don't. And I think they will. I mean, I
think, you know, I said it before and people kind of raised an eye. I think Billy Donovan is choice one.
No.
I think if you can get him.
No. Danny Hurley's choice one.
Well, you're not getting him.
Huh?
I wouldn't think.
I saw a report that said he's interested, but who knows?
Well, whoever reported that just did UConn a tremendous disservice.
When I saw,
they got the championship game tonight, and Danny Hurley's got to be talking about whether he's up for the Kentucky job.
They didn't ask him. When I saw last night, I was at the television station, and when I saw the report of some Arkansas guy Calipari is finalizing a deal to go to, I had to double check, triple check. Is anybody else reporting this? I don't believe this.
I believed it.
That's how crazy that was to me.
I believed it. I mean, don't know why they couldn't wait till after the championship game, though. That's a little annoying. What does it matter if you wait 2 days? Seriously. Do the same thing Wednesday morning instead of Sunday.
It's great for college basketball. Everybody's talking about it. So, but yeah, I see what it takes away from the
game. A little bit. Well, especially, since one of the coaches involved is going to be heavily linked.
I think they'll call Jay Wright. I think
Jay Wright ain't coming out, is what they say.
I think we know all the particulars. I think it's Jay Wright, Danny Hurley. I think those are the guys that you would focus on. I think
you would rather have them than Billy Donovan.
Yes.
Why? What? Ow! He's going quick. He's using them quick, man.
You want me to take it down?
No, that's fine. Right. That's good. That's fine. That's fine.
I don't know. Hurts. Is there any acting going on here?
Nah, it ain't no acting. Hey, things. Jeff going to tear my ass up tomorrow. Hey, I can dish it. I can take it.
I'm not acting. I mean, whatever.
No, this ain't
the way. It's not like unbearable. It just, it's
uncomfortable.
Like, it's like you ever got, like back in college, they hit you with those sticks? Mm-hmm. Hey.
Especially when you don't know what's coming.
I saw a fight one time. I was in college. The driver of the car, this is how stupid you are in college. Dude in the back seat reaches over and the driver of the car, who proceeds to turn around while we're driving,
car accident,
and punch him in the face.
Oh, gosh.
That's how we rolled back in these stupid days.
Yeah.
Back seat, driver while driving, turns around, punch in face.
Mm.
That's my crew.
Mm. But yeah, so I would not take Billy Donovan. Yeah.
You wouldn't?
Because I think that. And I don't, by the way, I'm not sure Billy Donovan wants to go deal with NIL
and all that. And I'm not
saying
that he
is. Would he be my number one choice?
Yeah,
no.
But why,
no.
Why? I guess my question is, why not?
I got Danny Hurley winning two championships right now. Well, that okay. 06 and 07 is a long time
ago.
What
do you mean? Like, Billy forgot how to, like, coach or recruit or any of that stuff? I mean, I don't know if he wants to.
You just said it's a different game he'd be jumping back into.
If Billy Donovan was at Kentucky, he'd send out 50 mailers and he'd get five top 50 players, right? Yeah, that's the thing. It's a little different than what he had to do at Florida.
I mean, Nate Oates is another guy.
Nate Oates, Scott Drew, I get it. Jay Wright, I get. Not this is my opinion. Obviously, I don't know him, but somebody, Farnham, said Jay Wright is never leaving. He's happy with what he's doing, so it won't be him. But
and you could convince Kentucky fan, by the way, and I think this guy would be great at Kentucky, and not have the early season or early tournament flameouts that he's had, Bruce Pearl.
I don't want him.
Yeah.
He's a clown. He's a good coach.
I love that guy.
Yeah. What's he won, Dan? Huh? Where's he ever been? What? No, not Bruce Pearl.
He turned Auburn around like that. Maybe Auburn ain't Kentucky in basketball. Say what you want.
Auburn ain't Arkansas in basketball.
No. So give him.
Well, just lost him. This is a bad argument, dude. They just lost in round one. The same thing that they get on Calipari.
I'm not sure he would lose like that at Kentucky, but because I think he's a good coach. Shoot, call Patino, see if you can get him for 3 years.
Now, see, you want Patino, but you don't want Billy Donovan.
Yeah,
well, I don't even know
Patino's
you.
Patino's still in the game.
But Donovan's in the game. You're giving way
in
too
the
much.
NBA.
Patino went to the NBA, came back and won.
He's an NBA guy.
Patino went to the NBA twice, came back and won Natties twice.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if you could get Billy Donovan, I would take Billy Donovan. He's the best college coach. I mean, Hurley's the only one that can match him, right?
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else? I mean, maybe Self?
Yeah, Bill Self.
You're not getting him. I'm not saying, but I'm just saying it's like current.
So, Arkansas went after Chris Beard and Jerome Tang from Ole Miss and Kansas State. Both would have made sense. Both said no thanks. And all of a sudden, they turned to Calipari and say, hey, you interested? Yeah, I'm interested.
Yeah, that was, like I said, that was Mike White, but on the penthouse floor instead of the 10th floor.
Yeah, Mike, yeah.
Like, it's the same type deal. You know, no one got fired, but yeah, the fan base had enough.
Mm-hmm.
And the coach is like, you don't appreciate me? Okay, I'll go to Arkansas then.
Mm-hmm.
And, but the postseason resume is alarming for Calipari, and it might not play out. He might not be able to, he's going to add that. It's going to make for an interesting next couple of years.
Well, it wasn't alarming when he first started, and he
right.
went to the
and maybe he
tournament
can
regional final, the Final Four, lost, won the tournament, missed a year, 21-12, by the way. 21-12, Kentucky doesn't get in. Lost the national tournament, national final, lost in the semi. I mean, he went to four Final Fours in his first 6 years. Then second round, regional final, regional semifinal, regional final, missed 2 years. One was COVID. Lost in the first round, second round, and first round the last 3 years. 23-10, 22-12, 26-8.
The recency bias certainly is.
Yeah. I mean, it's been, again, Kentucky has not done anything since 19, and that's too long for a Kentucky fan.
It's been 10 years since they went to the Final Four.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. But and that's how
the
they
final,
judge.
And, right. The final, and I get it. I understand how it's time to part. I do.
Yeah.
But I also understand that getting a better coach when the season starts, obviously the way they finished, I just don't know.
Yeah.
I don't here's why, Dan. I've sat here and watched Kentucky play this game. It worked twice. It worked with Patino and Calipari. Every other guy they tried to get, and there hadn't been that many, but I mean, even Eddie Sutton didn't win at Kentucky.
Well, what do you mean by win?
Win a championship.
Well, Tubby won a championship.
Yeah, Tubby was just, Larry Cokard won. You're right. He did win one, but he didn't last. He was gone in a hot minute.
Yeah. Well, no, he was there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10
that
years.
That surprised me he's there that long.
Billy Gillespie's the one who
Yeah, I knew him.
Billy Gillespie was a disaster. Joe B. Hall won a national. Kentucky has five guys who've won Natty championships. They're not the argue. They're not the school to make the argument for. Because I heard this the other day on a show. It's like how many different schools have won with at least three different coaches. It ain't many. And one of them is Kentucky has five. Kansas, right? They've won. And Carolina maybe? So, Kentucky's one of a bunch of different dudes. I mean, you go Rupp, Hall.
I think the NIL, too.
Tino, Tubby, and Cal.
I think the NIL is a much bigger pain in the butt to manage, by the way. Like, if you're a coach taking it over, it's a headache if it's football because of the roster sizes. I imagine managing your NIL needs and issues are a lot easier in basketball.
The NIL is what would annoy me as much as the portal would annoy me.
Well, the portal is different, but I you know what? Guess who doesn't lose their best players to the portal typically? The powers. I mean, the teams that lose their kids to the portal are UT Chattanooga's best player plays for, the Gators or Kansas or wherever he goes.
Yeah. If you're not playing, then, you may want to.
This is probably best for both sides. Arkansas is certainly a big enough boy for Calipari to win if he can win. That's all I'm saying. Maybe he can't anymore. I don't know. It's weird how it just totally flipped. When you weren't. Freshmen have always played big roles.
Yeah, they can play a big role, but they're not. When you're going up against 23 and 24 year olds, it's a little bit different.
So, I mean, Shepherd and Dillingham were those who were the freshmen for Kentucky. I mean, they had some experienced players. It wasn't. Oh, yeah. I think maybe he got a pass on that being the reason why this year. I just think he did a poor job with them. Mm-hmm. Like Antonio Reeves, he's been around.
Yeah, he's been around.
The big guy, the Visich that they got in the transfer, these guys. So it wasn't. It's not like he ran six freshmen out there, and that's why they lost. So that would give me pause.
Big day today, total solar eclipse, but not here.
Go stare at the sun. It's bad for you, kids.
I don't understand that. Why is it?
It's just too bright.
I remember
rods and cones get all screwed up.
Pick. I remember as a kid. We had to construct this thing to look at the solar eclipse with like a manila folder.
Yeah, they won't
let
you do that anymore.
And I'll look down.
Like some wax paper or
something. Don't look up!
Like they say, don't even look through your phone.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, whatever. Ian and I talked about this the other day. Mm-hmm. What time is this eclipse at?
Man, I have no clue.
Man, I could be in the inside, outside, taking a nap. I don't give
it's like at 4 o'clock.
Yeah, I don't care at all about looking at the eclipse. That doesn't register with me one single
bit.
There's
people like traveling.
It's amazing
to go see it.
You want to see an eclipse? It's no different than this. Go stand outside and wait for a cloud to pass in front of the sun. Ooh, look at that. The sun's blocked by a cloud. It happens every day.
Oh, dear. Sort of negative about the
eclipse. No, it's not negative. It's just silly, man. Mm-hmm. We have a country of just frivolous silliness. People that take time off, they push back the start time of the Yankees game because of the eclipse.
Well, you can't, yeah.
What do you mean you can't?
Well, you can't go. Well,
there's a high fly ball.
Judge is blind.
He's blind. He's been blinded.
Blind.
Two to four here, 147 to 419. People on the text line telling me that.
Oh, yeah. It's exciting.
You know, back to your, I'm seeing a text and it's reminding me of something on your deal. You gave, with that 17 pick, you gave a lot of options. How about dealing the 17 pick outside of the draft? Was that one of them? I know you talk about trading up, trading back, taking wide receiver, taking corner. The more I sit and think about it, Dan, the more I want to put together every package I can and get Justin Jefferson right now and just put that to bed.
I'm all for
it. And put him with Trevor, and then no more excuses, no more nothing. Yeah. Trade your first, trade your third, trade next year's second, and pay Justin Jefferson, and pay Josh Allen, and pay Trevor Lawrence, and let's go.
Yeah, I would agree
because
with that.
I don't trust this guy, adding through the draft or through second level free agency. Gabe Davis ain't Calvin Ridley.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think that would be a game changer.
And I haven't heard anything to that end, but man, I sure would like him to do it. And this value that they put on the young players is so overstated, way overstated. You could have traded last year's second through seventh, and gotten Justin Jefferson, and it would have been a better draft than what you stuck with. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, 100%.
Last year, the Jaguars could have traded picks two, their second rounder through their multiple seventh rounders, 8 or 9, 10 picks in all for Justin Jefferson, and it would have been more of a net positive than who they brought in.
All right, 641-1010, come kind, come courteous, come correct. E, tell them what they're going to win.
Floral arrangement delivery from Kuhn Flowers. Plus, the winner will also get entered for a chance to participate in the annual 1010XL Goofing Golf Tournament. Mm-hmm. Winner will be selected April 10th.
All right, we'll keep it rolling right here on The Drill. It's a shock Monday. Next.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Serving one of the fastest growing cities in America.
It don't get no better than this.
I guess it's no longer a best kept secret. 1010XL, Jacksonville Sports Radio.
Hey, certainly facing interesting economic times. I can't speak for everyone, but for me, comforting to know my money's in good hands with ITP Partners. Jacksonville guys taking care of my Jacksonville money, gang. I'm not an expert when it comes to investing. I don't get the difference between 401ks and SEP IRAs, but I do know this. As I move closer to retirement, my money's growing. That's because I got the experts at ITP Partners. And that's Dan Abel. That's Reagan Wright. That's Reed Wingate. That's Jeff Hartman. That's Chris Bryan. Those are the ITP Partners. Not just me. Three generations of Hickens, friends, family, use Jacksonville's ITP Partners. And they, why? Because they listen. They give us each individualized strategies. Our goals are their priority. What a great time to get started investing. ITP Partners are always there to help. For more info, Chris at ITPPartners.com. Chris at ITPPartners.com or give a call, 312-9751, 312-9751. Remember the name, ITP Partners, my financial partners for life.
I like to be active, and as you get older, I know it because I am older. You're more prone to injury, and I could not get rid of the pain.
QC Kinetics patient Diane Richardson talking about how a hiking injury left her in awful pain.
No one wants to live in pain. I certainly don't want to live in pain. I don't have time for pain.
Diane had heard about regenerative medicine, so she called QC Kinetics and started treatment right away, and the results were incredible.
I couldn't believe it. I honestly was skeptical, but the pain went from a 10 to a 0.
QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in using natural biologics, healing properties from your own body to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. There's no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime.
The result was phenomenal. I mean, I was not feeling any pain. I'm able to do everything that I want to do.
If you have pain from arthritis or injury, this may be the solution you're looking for. Call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation.
It was a game changer.
904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. 904-274-5522.
Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser start the week by giving the ball to the best back in Duval.
Hand off, Fred Taylor.
Monday morning running back with Fred Taylor is fueled by Epstein and Robbins and B&B Fuel and Lubricants on 1010XL.
Clearwater.
John, I can't even mow my side yard. It's so soggy. Man, my builder sucks.
Brent, calm down. This is a common problem in neighborhoods where houses are built too close together. You need gutters and a properly installed French drain that will soak up subsurface water. We can completely dry it up.
So I can take my builder off my speed dial now, huh?
Yeah, we got you, buddy. Let that builder bitterness go.
Clearwater Irrigation.
And drainage, too.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
It's March basketball. That means a host of top teams will be competing for the NCAA title. When it comes to commercial painters, there's also some healthy competition out there. Jason Parker with Performance Painting. To help you know the right questions to ask any painter competing for your business this year, visit PerformancePaintingJax.com. Or if you're ready for a friendly quote, give us a call and ask about our free pressure wash promotion for your next project. Performance Painting, quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Dandy Foods. Dandy subs and sandwiches, look, we always want you to think about those great options as you're driving around Duval. But the beauty is, even as I'm dropping pounds, Dandy's got great options for me as well. Told you all about their protein packs, delicious salads that they have out there. They have fruit cups for on the go. You know what they have, veggie snack trays. You can grab those on the go as well. Perfect healthy snack. Dandy is the name to know when you're on the go. So stop into a Gate store anywhere around Duval and make yours a Dandy. And do it today.
Your cooling system isn't working. Maybe somebody showed up with a portable electronic device. Then they discussed with you what your options are. Maybe they gave you an estimate that seems like an awful lot of money. What's the smart thing to do? When the situation merits a second opinion, get a Mike Merritt opinion. Yes, the Mike Merritt Comfort Team shows up with hand tools. We've never been able to fix an air conditioning problem with a tablet. Mike Merritt has been the trusted name for more than 30 years because there's never any hocus pocus. The Merritt team will walk you through the diagnostic steps up close and personal and show you exactly what you need. And the Mike Merritt price is likely to be far less because there's never an overtime charge, and the Merritt team doesn't work on commission. So remember, when it comes to the health of your cooling system, a second opinion can only help, and a Mike Merritt opinion can save you money. Florida license CACO 50384.
AgPro Sign and Drive event is offering 0% for 84 months with no money down on a John Deere compact utility tractor with loader. Limited time offer. Visit your local AgPro dealer today. Offer ends April 30th, 2024. Subject to approved credit. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Has someone you care about been arrested or had their driver's license taken away? I'm Susan Cohen, and I work with David Robbins at the law firm of Epstein & Robbins. We are experienced fighters for those charged with DUI, domestic violence, and all criminal offenses. In your battle with the justice system, there's only one thing you need to know. Dial David, 24-7 at Epstein & Robbins, 354-5645. 354-5645.
Yo, E to the T here, and if you're still in the market for a sports book to call home, bet that nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is your one-stop shop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with that Vegas life experience right from that cellular device of yours, my boy. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the website. Sign up now and take advantage of the generous welcome bonus on your first deposit all the way up to $1,000. Put in two, get back three. Ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun don't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you decide where to put that cash at. And the best part about MyBookie, you can bet anything, anytime, anywhere. And don't forget that promo code 1010XL. Come on, somebody.
First Coast, I'm sure by now you have seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We're an industry leader in solid waste and would love the opportunity to earn your business. We're committed to customer service, reliability, and have an unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today from GFL, green for life.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
I think between the solar eclipse, or what is it, solar, between the solar eclipse and the shock collar, which
it's
is
electric.
Zap me.
Woogie, 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 woogie.
Twice already. I feel like it's messing with the
seven to go.
It's hard to put
it's electric
a choke label on a dude who birdied eight straight holes to make a playoff.
Yeah.
But it all is superseded by absolutely gagging on a 100-yard pitch shot.
Oof.
And Denny McCarthy yesterday, who put the best putting around in the history of the PGA Tour.
It was unbelievable.
Yeah, 91 putts. The
he birdied eight of the nine holes on the back.
Yeah, eight, I think it was eight in a row. If it went eight in a row.
11.
Seven,
no, 11
seven in a row, eight of nine on the back.
But
to
you know
to
what?
Come from way back to make it. He had a 100-yard middle of the fairway
wedge shot. He was like this,
wedge
shot. I could tell. I didn't call the. I didn't think he'd dunk it in the creek.
I mean, he left it 30 yards short, a total amateur.
I don't know if he plays like this or if this was just.
No, he does. Yeah, that whole.
With this, with the feet,
yeah, that's
and
what
then
he does.
He doesn't settle, yeah. And then he goes.
Yeah, that's what
and
he
I'm
does.
I'm like, what are you.
As good as he putted, his wedge game was kind of sketch yesterday. I was flipping around. I was watching most of the South Carolina, Iowa game,
mm-hmm.
or the Caitlin Clark show, I call it.
Mm-hmm.
But I was watching the golf, and I had McCarthy in our fantasy. I was the only one that had him.
Oh.
So I needed him to win. It would have been a nice boost. Finishing second just keeps me, you know, in line with everyone else because a few had Batia. But, yeah, you come all the way back. You make eight birdies on the back nine, and you can't execute a 100-yard, you know, 56 degree. It's amazing.
Yeah.
That was along the lines. That sticks in my mind among the two biggest wedge chokes I've ever seen. The other was Spieth. We'll actually go three with Vandeveld. Remember Spieth at the Masters? hit it in 12, and then took a drop and hit it in there, and then he just chunked one right in the middle of the pond.
Yeah. Yeah, that but that was a stunner, as well as Denny McCarthy was playing. I guess Denny McCarthy, I saw this, he's from the same class, same age as Spieth and JT, and used to beat them on the juniors and
wonders why he doesn't
have the success here. And that could have some, I mean, golly, I give Batia credit because, man, McCarthy caught him, passed him, birdied 18, forcing Batia to have to make a 11.5-foot putt, he drained it.
Batia also became the first player in a long time to injure his shoulder with a golf fist pump celebration. Yeah. And I don't want to say golfers are soft, but when you're throwing your shoulder out because you gave a fist pump.
Yeah. But anyway, it was
what a story that kid is, though. He's a fun, fascinating story, and this is why the PGA Tour maintained its relevance through the split, is because, you know, he gets into the Masters not coming off some country club soiree at Doral like Sergio Garcia, who was already in Augusta, didn't need to win. Doesn't matter if he wins. Batia's got to win.
Sergio hit it in the water to lose.
Yeah,
did
he?
Yeah, I think so.
I thought he ended up winning, but I don't know. I don't
care.
No,
this guy Burmester.
I don't watch LIV.
There's nobody on Twitter worse than the LIV Golf Insider. The LIV Golf Insider just spews lies.
Okay.
Like, just flat out lies. Right. He's got 6,000 followers, including me. I like to see what's happening on LIV Golf, and I don't watch it.
All right.
But he just, it's just one after another after another. He takes shots at everybody if you're not on, but it's not funny. Like, like, this is what he, the most coveted trophy in sports, top five ball striker Dean Burmester has realized LIV Golf individual glory.
Glory, huh?
Yeah. Or, I mean, it's just like, zero drama at the PGA Tour JV playoff. Both no-name players lay up on a par five. Informed golf fans are watching Sergio and Clean Dean battle out for their individual LIV Golf title. And then Sergio hit it in the water just like McCarthy did.
Nice. I don't think that... I don't think that's a shock number three of the hour. So
that was 757.
Yeah,
that's well done right there.
I knew it had to come. I was on alert, and it got me anyway.
Yeah,
listen.
I don't love it, Jim. Yeah. I swear, I don't love doing it.
All right.
I know, I'm taking it like a champ. What?
What's the level?
Three. Where you told me leave it at?
You can.
I ain't gonna crank it up.
No, he's about to say it, then he backed down. He's about to say, no, you crank it up. I don't care.
You don't have to back it down. You don't have to crank. You can do whatever.
No,
I don't care.
All right.
It's noticeable. It's not. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you I'm getting tased, but it's noticeable.
In the face.
In the face. And if y'all are wondering, Miss P, not let me put it on my neck. If you want to put it on your neck, no be a way. Tough guy. Go ahead. Knock yourself out. Y'all have a party, and y'all shock yourself in the neck.
Drink your four loco.
I got it in different spots. I'm moving it around so I don't get prong burned.
I have said this about my Gator baseball team all year. I don't think they're very good.
Low point this weekend.
I think they've made they had a kid coming in from UCLA. I think you got to get transfer portal pitching. I don't think you can rely on freshmen. And I think that's what happened with this group. And I think that then they went into a team slump, hitting-wise, and so they didn't hit the ball very well, and that was unfortunate. They broke out of that yesterday, but they're up 10-8, and they can't get three outs in the ninth inning. They let them tie it up. It was some bad coaching, too, man. He should have brought in the McNeely kid to start, give him a clean inning. He let the other kid who had pitched the day before stay out there, and he walked the first two. And what happened was 1-8 Missouri is now 4-8, and 6-3 Florida with three series wins is now 6-6, and 17-14 overall. Gang, they ain't hosting no regional.
No, nor should they.
And they have South Carolina at Vandy, at Arkansas, Tennessee, and Kentucky, who's 11-1.
And Calipari's coaching Arkansas now.
Coming up. So, good luck. 3 1-run losses. They got Tallahassee on Tuesday. And they're a 500 club. And now they've lost. The street cred is now gone. They're going to plummet in the rankings. I don't think they should be ranked. I don't think they will be ranked. They were sixth going into the weekend. They needed at least two out of three. Missouri's not as bad as the record. However, they're not great, and you got to go win those games. You got to win the series, and they didn't. They got two hits in 11 innings on Friday night. It was a disastrous. It was a disastrous weekend for Florida baseball. So keep it up, and they're going to play them. So LSU's 3-9, I think, in the SEC. Look, the SEC.
Those are your two World Series finalists last
year. And we're going to rue not winning it last year and wasting Jack Caggs, the best player in college baseball, who, though, has battled wildness and was wild yesterday, left the game down 7-1. And to Florida's credit, they rallied back. They took the lead, and they couldn't hold it. They cannot hold leads. Their pitching staff is not good enough, and now their hitting is they got to get hot again, which they will. They have good hitters. But they're going to have to win. They can't win. They can't. I don't think they can.
Or deep enough in to know that the pitching's not good enough. They get hit by everyone.
We're 31 games in, dude.
They get hit by middle week lesser programs. So I've been sent this on the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures. The answer would certainly be different for different people. So I'm going to change the parameters for you after I read it as it was sent.
Mm-hmm.
You have a 3-stroke lead going into 18 on Augusta on Sunday. You need a double bogey or better to win the tournament. If you're successful, you win the Masters and first place money, $3.5 million. If you fail, you go to prison for a year. Are you doing it? You'd almost have to ratchet this by handicap level. So I would say this, Dan. If you could play if you make a 9,
yeah,
you win $3.5 million and win the Masters. Yeah. If you make a 10 or more,
yeah,
you go to prison for a year.
It all comes down to that tee shot.
Would you do it?
Yeah, I'd give it a shot.
For a 9 you would?
Yeah.
A year in prison now.
Yeah, I know.
It's not just a, hey,
that's
you get
me. I'm Mr.
Million.
Vegas. I give it a shot.
I would do the double bogey or better. And I would play it like this. I would hit 4-iron, 4-iron wedge, and just try like heck to get on the green.
Well, 18, you got to get it through those trees.
Yeah.
Now, they do. The good news there is if you hit it in the trees, you usually got an opening to punch it
just
out.
Just get in play.
Yeah.
Like
what, so you want to really advance the ball. For me, I think I can advance it. You're going uphill. And the problem at Augusta is if you haven't played there, which we haven't, the greens ain't easy. So you probably need a little local flavor to tell you where to putt it.
Well, you know what? That's where. And again, I'm this.
Are we Sunday pin placement up front?
This isn't a
front left.
This isn't a brag. But as a pretty decent golfer, the best thing that I do by a mile is putting. So that's why I would be more comfortable taking this bet.
Yeah, yeah.
You can be a really good player if you're not a good putter. To your point, you'll five putt that joker.
Yeah. So you can. So if you can, you knock it, you get it. And it's uphill. You got to get it up out in there. And then if you can get it up around the green in, for me, if I can get it up around the green in 3, which I think I can, and then honestly, I don't even have to chip. I can probably just putt it from in front of the green there. Now, I don't want to go in the sand, Jeffrey. We got bunkers there on the right and left.
No, like I said, I'm hitting 4-iron to like 100 yards and then just trying to get a wedge on the green just to like just – I'm not trying to make a par or birdie. That way, not that approach. I've got to – and by the way, I may fail. I'm just saying I would do it. I'd be willing to at least try. By the way, let's hear it for the girls. And we talked about South Carolina v. Caitlin Clark.
Uh-huh.
But Nelly Korda yesterday
she won again,
the LPGA. She's won 4 straight now on the LPGA Tour. And I think she's only the second woman to ever win at least 4 in a row.
That was like I flipped through. It was like a match play or something that they were in?
Yeah, that was her match play event this week.
Okay.
Lorena Ochoa was the last player to win 4 consecutive in 08. Nancy Lopez did it in 78. Annika Sorensen did it in 04, 05. I just gave you 3 of the biggest names in women's golf history.
Mm-hmm.
Right? With those 3, Ochoa, Sorensen, and Nancy Lopez, I threw Kari Webb in and that's probably your 4 biggest names in golf history. So Nelly Korda made some yesterday on the LPGA
Good
Tour.
For her.
I have 20 questions for you when we come back.
Oh, I love 20 questions.
The Monday Morning Quarterback, divorcemenonly.com.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
Now hear this.
Here's 1010XL's new line.
We're sending you back to the future.
Buckle up.
Dan and Jeff in the morning. Mike and Tony 10 to noon. Mia, Lauren and Taylor noon to 2. Joe, Matt and Leon 2 to 4. Frank and Hayes 4 to 6. And Rick and Hacker in the evening.
We invite you now to listen.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is a great time of the year to get that home in tip-top quality shape, and that's what Rhino Shield can do for you. Man, can they paint your house? They can paint your small business. They can paint anything. And they have a beautiful, durable coating. And I'm telling you, it never chips, cracks, or peels. And they back it up. Here's a, not 5, not 10, 25-year warranty. No mold, mildew, and algae growth. None of that water intrusion damage from nasty weather and hurricane force winds. Fight salt corrosion Class A fire rating. Guess what? Saves you thousands compared to the cost of repainting. With 0% financing and new low pricing up to 25% off, what a great time. It's never been easier to paint your home with Rhino Shield. Say, Hick, what do I do? I want this. Get your free estimate today. I said free. Free estimate at rhinoshieldjax.com. Go to rhinoshieldjax.com. You'll be glad you did.
I'm Frank Frangie with the Nimnik Nugget. Draft talk for a second. Is it corner and it's over? I mean, I'm trying to remember a time when this many people were this convinced they knew who the Jaguars were going to take. I mean, and that doesn't mean they're right, but I can't remember a time when this many people seemed this convinced. Does it seem that way to you? It just seems like to me, it almost seems that why are we having a draft? We all know it's going to be Terry and Arnold or some other corner. I'm Frank Frangie for the Nimnik family of dealerships. There are trucks, and then there's the truck, the GMC Sierra. Frank Frangie here, with available features like the V8 engine, the ultimate luxury interior, and of course, the available world's first six-function multi-pro tailgate. Nimnik Buick GMC has the largest inventory of GMC Sierras in the area. This month, save up to $10,000 off new GMC Sierra 1500 or enjoy rates as low as 1.9% APR financing. You get it at Nimnik. GMC, we are professional grade.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement, plus no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
Now that's what I call high-quality H2O.
If you want high-quality water throughout your home, call your local water boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. WaterboyJAX.com.
Home of the Jaguars. WJXL-AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL-FM Jacksonville Beach.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Bueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les.
By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Test your aim to help local kids succeed. It's the 6th annual Mackenzie Noel Wilson Foundation Clay Shoot to support the Boys and Girls Clubs of Northeast Florida and Mackenzie's Camp Deep Pond, Thursday, May 13th at Jack's Clay Target Sports. Get your team and the Boys and Girls Club take care of the rest. Ammo, cart, clays, breakfast bites, lunch, and goodies. Proceeds benefit 56 area clubs serving over 5,200 area kids every day. Go to bgcnf.org/events.
When my wrist pain was acting up and I needed help, I took Dan Higgins' advice and headed over to see the experts at Southeast Orthopedic Specialists. This is Stuart Moore with the PGA Tour. I highly recommend Southeast Orthopedic Specialists. Whenever you have a need, they took great care of me. They'll take great care of you.
This is Dr. Kevin Murphy. The next time you need orthopedic care, you can rely on our team at Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Instant Keys. You don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you. For lost or broken keys or nearly any make and model of vehicle, call 722-1111 for Instant Keys Locksmith Service.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. FSU football head coach Mike Norvell, following the spring scrimmage, commented on the improvement he sees in running back Lawrence Toffielli.
He made his presence felt early. And, a couple good runs, a couple good plays. He catches the ball, so well. So it's all about getting better. LT has definitely improved.
Players Jose Devers and Otto Lopez each lashed three hits, and the Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp earned a series win on Sunday over the Durham Bulls. Devers tripled to jumpstart the seventh seventh. After a ground out, he scored on Lopez RBI single to get the victory. Our Major League teams around the state saw the Orlando Magic defeat the Chicago Bulls. Miami Heat lost to the Indiana Pacers in the NBA. The Tampa Bay Rays won over the Colorado Rockies, and the Marlins got the W from the St. Louis Cardinals in the MLB. That's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update. I'm Sam Nelson.
It's 8:10 and it's 58 degrees. Your time and your temp is brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Baby, this is what you came for. Lightning strikes every time she moves.
Second hour of Shock Monday.
Smoking.
Three shots in, six to go. Are you back on yet or no?
Yeah, that's fine.
Where'd you put it?
I got it on the left thigh here. Oh, God.
Crank that sucker up, baby. Give him a good one.
Hey, man,
and Jeff got a special thing. We don't need you to mess that up.
He tested it on himself and said that it shocked him pretty good, and then he bumped it up one from that, right? Yours was on two, right?
Yeah, mine was – no, whenever I shot myself, it was on five.
Oh, yeah, when you went crazy.
Yeah.
Let's take a phone call here real quick, and then I got 20 questions.
All right.
Ow! You don't mess around, man.
Shock and awe.
Over here, I'm all paranoid that you've messed up like something with my muscles over here, or some twitching going on in the other
one. You're
going
to be running a mile in like six minutes.
Yeah. Put it under me. Hello, Glenn. Good morning.
Hey, Glenn.
Morning, guys.
Hey. How are we doing?
I'm good.
Good.
Now that I'm retired from Phil, this is the first time I've ever discussed live golf with you guys on the air. Would you agree?
Yeah, for the most part.
Yeah. Yeah, tell me the difference between the guys that jump to live golf and the following. Artis Gilmore, Louis Dampier, George McGinnis, Dan Issel, and Dr. J.
NBA to ABA, is what you're saying.
Yeah. And how about when the Boston Bruins, who have just won the Stanley Cup, had three of their best players, including Derek Sanderson, jump to the World Hockey Association, and then they decided to come back, and they were welcome with open arms.
Well, you could do Zonka. You could do Zonka and Kick and Warfield.
And all the rest of them. Tell me the difference.
Well, I mean, there's some. I think it'd be more like if you left the NFL and then instead played Madden. They went to the best player. They went to Patrick Mahomes and said, Mahomes will play you $200 million a year if you play Madden.
Oh, no.
Some
Come
exhibition
on. You
football. 54 holes, Glenn.
No,
there's no competition, dude. You're all making your money already. I mean, you know better than this. For a competitive edge.
No, you're wrong.
They're competing. They're competing on PGA Tour for their livelihood.
Let me ask you,
for their livelihood. That's why.
Let me ask you this question.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this question.
Sure.
PGA Tour is a 501c3.
Don't care about all that, Glenn. Charity. No one cares. Let's don't get into the business makeup and model. No one cares. Sports fans don't care.
Why?
Because we don't care what athletes make. We want to see them strive at the upper edge of competition for their livelihood. That's what we want to see as fans.
Then had you been on the air where all those players went to the ABA, what would you have said?
I would have said that's competition. They're not playing on a 48-foot floor on 8-foot rims in with total different rules and parameters of what competitive basketball.
You know
had
what it is,
been.
Too, Glenn. You know what's annoying about the LIV Tour? It's the guys who are there. With all due respect, I don't want to talk about Phil. I want to talk about Greg Norman telling me that Taylor Gooch is the best iron player he's ever seen. That's the most asinine comment in the history of sport. So that's the kind of stuff that sits here and makes us shake our head at the stupidity.
And there's also this too, Glenn. They didn't the guys that left for the ABA or the WFL or these other ones, they didn't go and sue where they left, despite making more money where they're headed. These guys are just—it's just the wrong horse to ride into battle for me. The biggest—I'll say it again. This is the last thing I'll say. Mm-hmm. I'll say it again. The biggest obstacle most PGA Tour players have ever faced in their life is the soda machine going down when they're 10 years old on the junior circuit. They get in their Escalades with their $1,000 car, golf clubs, and live a pampered life forever, and they complain they're not making enough in a sport that no one's watching.
But we appreciate you bringing it up.
I
good
do.
Stuff, Glenn.
Thank you, Glenn.
Thank you, buddy.
All right, I got 20 questions.
All right, let's go.
Ran into a guy around the golf course this weekend.
Give me a pen.
And I was surprised. Well, I mean, I need a pen to mark off the questions also. Yoda, run Dan Hicken a pen here. Thank you. I ran into a guy at the golf course, around the golf course this weekend. I won't say which one, who informed me that he's made a hole-in-one on number 17.
Okay.
Ooh, Island Green?
On the Island Green.
Ooh. Okay.
It didn't seem fair, considering that this guy is already a well-established celebrity. And that's all you're getting, and good luck.
You ran into a guy playing golf who told
around the golf course. Around the golf course. When actually playing with him.
All right, let's just throw one out for fun. Josh Scobie.
Okay, Scobie, that's a good guess. It's not Scobie.
No, shout out Scobes.
Yeah, Scobie might he may have a hole in one at 17. I don't know.
Is it a is it a man?
Yes.
Is it a former athlete?
Yes.
Former athlete.
One thing is for sure, this will definitely be better than the Urban Meyer. You'll do a better job. I got sidetracked.
Did he play football?
Yes. That's a nice lucky guess there. It's an athlete, right? The football player. This will be easy now. I'm going to say 11 questions. We'll get it in 11.
Former NFL player. Did he play for the Jags?
Well, you said NFL, but anyway, football. He did not play for the Jags, no.
Clown question, bro.
Is he known for playing? Did he play in the NFL?
Yes.
And a waste of question because of that little thing,
man.
You threw me.
I had to do what I got to do. You did that to me the other day.
Clown question, bro.
I asked you, was he a broadcaster? And you went, that's all he does is broadcast.
Formula.
Did he play?
I guess it just surprised me that the dude has a hole-in-one that he plays that, you know, anyway.
Did not play for the Jags.
No.
Played in the NFL.
He did. Six questions in. You got this.
And he doesn't play anymore.
He's a former player. That's correct.
All right. Is he...
Dan, what do you think if you ask if he's a former offensive player or a defensive player?
I was thinking about that. Did he play offense?
Yes.
Okay.
Didn't play for the Jags. Offensive player.
How many questions is that, Jeffrey?
7.
All right,
Dan, you got to get some big ones here.
Yeah, I know. All right. Did he play high school ball in Jacksonville?
No.
So he lives here now. He didn't play high school ball in Jacksonville. Did he go to
very surprised that a person of this celebrity stature had a hole in one on 17. Never fancied him as that.
Did he go to Florida?
No. Or 9. You're getting off track here a little bit. I'm starting to worry about 20. We can as a group.
You're very surprised. Did he play offensive line?
No.
Which means he's not.
I guess I'm surprised. I just didn't know this dude was a golfer. I've never seen him on the celebrity tour. I mean, it's a big name. It's big enough that he would play in that Tahoe event if he, you know. That level, I think. Celebrity.
You ran into him at a golf course.
I was around a golf course.
Okay.
Yeah, I was around a golf course when I talked to him. Yeah. Talked to him for a while. Weren't playing golf, per se. It would clarify some things, but I need to at least say part of the story till after you do your guesses. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm not trying to we are 10 questions in. Ran into a celebrity around the golf course this weekend who I was surprised to find out has a hole-in-one on 17. I was asking him just how much golf he plays and whatnot, and then I also found out that he's got 3 holes in one total.
Which, oh, wow.
Yeah. Made me even more bitter when I told him the story about, well, that's funny. You know, we do a radio show and every morning. It's a bit that I've never had one. So
I'm just trying to figure out.
I don't like you. Yeah, it's pretty wide open now. You've got I would concentrate on the offensive player.
Does he live in Jacksonville?
No, he does not.
That's the problem. He came in for the event that Prosser went to.
There you go.
So that's the
issue. You go. I didn't want to say that first because it would have saved you about 5-6 questions.
Yeah. So it was a Tebow event on Friday night.
I was at the Tim Tebow celebrity golf gala, correct. The fundraiser that night. But the work that young man is doing, man, on the world stage is awfully impressive.
We got to figure out who he invited, who came, who went to the
research allowed. We got to guess.
Events. Yeah, like who rocked with Tibby.
Yeah, we can't be going to the celebrity list. That would be cheating. Mm-hmm. Just got to kind of go with,
All right, where are we on questions?
I think that's 11.
Scobie has texted me that he does not have an ace on 17, but he has 2 on 9, which I'm guessing that's 8 he means. Does 9 to par 5.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go.
We got an offensive, former offensive player.
Was he a quarterback?
No, he wasn't. You know he wasn't an offensive lineman. You know he wasn't a quarterback, so really leaves only 2 other options there.
Skilled player.
Mm-hmm. Definitely a skilled player.
I would like
think it's going to be a
receiver. Go down the accomplishment lane, right? Let's start narrowing down just what level of player we're talking about here. I think that would help you.
He didn't go to Florida.
Find out if it's a former Super Bowl champ. What you think?
Nah, that doesn't help.
Okay.
Still way too many.
All right.
I'll be bailed. It's a very hard question, right? I mean, I get it, but I'll be bailed out because of the level of, of superstar. I'll get bailed out by that. This isn't, we're not going to get to the end here, and I'm going to give you Marvin Jones. I ran into Marvin this weekend.
Jerry Rice.
No, but there you go. That's a no.
Okay.
That's a no.
Was he an All-Pro?
Yes. 14 questions.
All pro.
It's going to be like a Chris Carter, Randy Moss, something like that.
It's a big name.
Yeah. You say superstar.
Is he a running back?
No.
So he's all pro receiver.
15.
All pro receiver.
Hines Ward, Steve Smith.
Probably played in the Tebow era. Who did Tebow? He didn't have any great, so it's not like Decker or anybody like that.
Not big enough name.
No. Who does Tebow work with at the SEC?
I'm going to say that Tebow is in some certain cliques and clubs that spans him across generations of football players. So I wouldn't narrow it down to he would have played like he's, what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Tebow's accomplished enough things that
he could pull
he's generational friends with certain, select groups that he's. We're at 15. I now feel that the question is fair. It's narrowed down enough now. There's one question you could ask that would win this for you. One question. You would get it on the next, or maybe 2 later.
He didn't play for the Jags, E.
He did not.
Ran into this guy at the Tim Tebow Foundation Gala. Raised a lot of money for a lot of fighting trafficking. I mean, this is yeoman's patriotic work that the whole Tebow Foundation. It was a lovely event. It was just a great people. Had a fun night. A star-studded event. Chip and Joanna Gaines were there. If you want to go outside of the sports world. And then a lot of football guests and so on. And this guy that I'm speaking of, which shares a special...
He's
in a special club with Tim Tebow. How about that? That's a big, big clue. This is
Heisman Trophy winner.
Yes. Ooh. He's a Heisman Trophy winner. That's 16.
There you go, right there.
All right, I got
it. I'm giving him a lot more help than he gave me on Urban. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
You should. Trying to keep it moving along for the audience, so that's all. Yeah.
How about... I don't...
Yeah, they're all saying Heisman winner on the text line.
Yeah. All right, so it's got to be...
Yeah.
I think I know it.
Yeah, me too.
But hang on before I... There's only very few wide receivers who have... There's 2 that I can think of.
Right.
So it's one or the other.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
I'm not a big fan of one of them, so I'll go with Tim Brown.
It's Tim Brown. There you go. Tim Brown. Question 17, right? And, but I was, does that surprise, I didn't know Tim Brown was a golfer, first of all. Mm-hmm. But I talked to him for a good piece on Saturday night, and he told me, yeah, he said he actually has a hole-in-one on 17, I guess at this event or maybe at a different time. But that's three for Tim Brown. That's not fair, man.
Yeah.
But the event was terrific, and again, they raised a lot of money and a lot of, I mean, heck, when I'm talking about it, this is like movie stuff that they're doing.
Oh, I know.
The Tebow Foundation. I mean, they're saddling up, you know, recon mission and saving children from just these things. We live in a bubble, man, of comfort here in the United States, and just some really, really just beyond touching, impactful stories that came out of that. But you know me, I'm going to come back with the I talked to Tim Brown angle.
This is The Drill on 1010XL, 92.5 FM.
The Drill, from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
We're way past big speech time. Anybody have anything they want to say?
Yeah. Let's win this one for all the small schools who never had a chance to get here. I want to win for my dad. Let's win for
1010XL.
Hey, it's one of life's most important decisions. Gang, if you're 18 years or older, you just got married, just got divorced, you have children, you likely want to take care of your family. That's why I'm telling you about Matt Hinson and the Hinson Law Firm. Matt's the attorney. I'm not. But listen, gang, I've got the question I know the answer to most of you will say. Have you done your last will? A lot of you say, Hick, I haven't done my will. I don't even do my will. Well, think about it. You want to get your assets to the people that you choose, okay? You want to make those decisions. You want to be in control. You want to minimize income, gift, and estate taxes as well. Matt Hinson's your guy. He's going to listen. He's going to help you with some tough decisions. He's going to provide you info needed so you are at ease with your choice. It's the Hinson Law Firm. You got questions? Matty's got the answers. Reach out, 527-1700. That's 904-527-1700. Office is Jacksonville, Florida. Don't let the state decide your fate.
Spring's here, and your home to-do list is getting longer. Don't stress. Fenwick Home Services has you covered 24/7 with cooling and plumbing solutions to fit any budget. From minor upgrades to major repairs, no matter your home's needs, we get it done and get it done right the first time. Schedule your seasonal AC tune-up today. Avoid costly breakdowns when our certified technicians inspect your system, ensuring it runs efficiently, and remove buildup, dust, pollen, and dander so you can breathe easier. Book now at fenwickhomeservices.com/radio.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
A lot of companies will tell you they're the best. At Custom Tree Surgeons, they show you every time. Custom Tree Surgeons has built an all-pro team. Every tree service professional has years of experience, continually trained and certified. They know what, when, and how to handle any job. It gets done efficiently and quickly by a team of experts. So for tree trimming, removal, stump grinding, and emergency services, forget any name other than Custom Tree Surgeons. There is no job they can't do better. Go to website, CustomTreeSurgeons.com. That's CustomTreeSurgeons.com. And let them show you how the job is supposed to get done.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
You know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh, they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Hick and here, gang. It's time to spring into action and refresh your vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. from dry eyes and allergies causing irritation to cataracts blurring your vision, Bowden Eye can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit BowdenEye.com to schedule your consultation. Bowden Eye & Associates, keeping the First Coast focused.
Chose C for CSS Fireplaces and Outdoor Living. They can transform your backyard with fire pits, pergolas, screen enclosures, and outdoor kitchens. And CSS handles the entire project from start to finish. You dream it, they build it. CSSOutdoor.com.
This is 1010XL, 92.5 FM.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit republicservices.com.
Equal opportunity.
This is Keith Catlin for Catlin Truck Accessories, and we are so blessed to be in business for over 100 years. Over 100 years of the best product and customer service means you can count on Catlin. From rolling lock bed covers to Lear toppers to cam locker toolboxes, Catlin Truck Accessories has you covered when it comes to your truck or van. We do those too. Got a fleet of vehicles? We can outfit them all.
Who can you count on? Count on Catlin.
One name, one location, 100 years. You can count on Catlin.
Best Bet is number one. That's right. Best Bet Jacksonville, Orange Park, and St. Augustine have one card poker. The fastest and easiest card game to learn and play. Play one card at a time, and the highest card wins even money. If the card values are the same, it's time for war. Just like the game you remember. You must be 18 years or older to play. More at bestbetjacks.com. That's bestbetjacks.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Now, Dan and Jeff hand it off to our halfback.
Fred Taylor, every time he touches it, he's a candidate to go the distance.
Monday morning running back with Fred Taylor is fueled by Epstein and Robbins DUI defense firm and B&B Fuel and Lubricants on 1010XL.
Blackberry is still chasing.
Always still chasing. Let's welcome in our guy, but we gotta tell you a couple things, Freddie T.
Oh,
as we welcome you to the show.
Okay, let's
Fred, if you hear Jeff scream, it's because he's wearing a Shock dog collar. Mm-hmm. He lost a bet.
Yeah,
and we get to shock him 9 times.
It's not good, Fred.
And we've shocked him.
What bet?
It was the March Madness.
It was March Madness.
Yeah, I finished last in our little March Madness bracket. The three of us: me, Hick, and ET.
Yeah.
But then, and so what we do here is we make these dime bets and we put Wheel of Consequence and we spin it. Whatever it lands on, you have to do. And I'm being shot collared today. Yeah. It's fantastic.
Come on.
It's all these years. This is what I've done, Fred. This is what I get all these years in the business. Uh-huh. Professionalism.
That has to be some sort of human abuse. Right?
Thank you.
You can't do that.
Yeah, I don't know, right?
I don't know, Fred. I once got my back waxed on live radio.
Yeah,
okay.
That's true, too.
No sympathy from this guy.
No, whacking your back or whatever it sounds like on radio doesn't sound good, but that sounds better than shock collaring. Come on.
It might, but that's what we're...
I got your back on this one. Hopefully they take it easy on you or either take the collar off.
He's not, by the way, for the record, he's not wearing the collar on the neck. We didn't want to intrude on the spinal area or whatever, so we've got it wrapped around the thigh. And
ow! Oh, okay.
And there he goes. He just got buzzed again.
Wow.
Attaboy.
Yeah, I let him up at one. He just
went on him.
Yeah, he upped one on me.
Yeah, we're gonna go hard on the last
we'll
one.
We'll be okay. Right?
Throw it on double digits on the last
Listen,
one.
Here's the deal,
happens.
Fred. These punishments, okay? They're one of two things usually. They're physical pain or they're embarrassment. And I'm a guy, I'd rather get the physical pain than the embarrassment. So wearing the collar today, don't feel sorry for me. I do not feel demeaned. Nor do I feel like I'm being, you know, absolutely tortured.
Yes.
This is what I want. This is my destiny for not being able to pick the tournament correctly. By the way, kudos to you, yeah. Fred Taylor.
Yeah.
Very in tune and in line with that NCAA women's tournament and just how popular and how momentous it was going to be.
Yeah.
And it helped having Caitlin to the very end, too. That's for sure.
Without a doubt, I think it lived up to all expectations for those that, you know, were interested in it to begin with. It did not let us down. And for all of the newcomers, I mean, they broke a record almost each and every game from the, you know, from the Elite Eight forward. So, you know, shout out to those women, man. I think they did a fantastic job in helping, you know, put eyes and visibility on their sport. And I hope it'll continue to grow. Caitlin Clark, she is absolutely a monster out there. Man, so much respect to Caitlin. You know, it's just one of those things, man, when you see the great players, and it saddens me that they can't or they don't always go out on top with, you know, with the rings, the trophy, the championships,
right,
that sort of stuff. Because it seems like, you know, with how hard they play in, that their stardom should also be followed up by winning a championship. And it can't happen on all levels. But hopefully she'll be able to go to the WNBA and make you know, something out of an organization where she does get a couple championships, because I think she's very much deserving.
It'll be interesting to see if the bounce applies to the WNBA. The part of me that's been following sports and coverage for so long thinks this is going to be a college story, right? And when you get to the WNBA, which is not near as popular to the TV viewers as college women's college basketball is, it, you know, it. But we'll see. They're certainly in the transition stage. In the transition stage, it'll be there. Fred, how much would you put together to trade for Justin Jefferson? Like, if you were the Jags right now, would you trade like this year's first and third and next year's first to get Justin Jefferson? Understanding too that we've got salary, you know, parameters that you've got to stay within. But is that a deal worth being that aggressive to make, or something along those lines?
I mean, yeah, first and a third and the first a year from now, or maybe even stagger. I don't know if you want to push way out to 26, but he's one of those talents, man. It's hard to say no to it, but you also have to look at, like, how much do we want to mess around with our future? Like, that's the draft capital. I mean, you can get anybody at those levels, or you can go in there and say this stock is proven. So I think I would.
It's a tough question, isn't it?
It's a tough question. He's such a good player, but you have to, you know, you have to be in the moment. You have to play for now a lot of the times, and not necessarily wait for the future. Like, let's look at the Rams. What the Rams put together and what they gave up, and they went out and they won it.
They won it.
Right? Their gamble paid off.
Yep.
And everyone said they're going to not be that good going forward. They had to shake up their roster, get rid of a lot of those guys. A lot of those guys, you couldn't even recognize the roster with Odell Beckham, Von Miller being gone, Jalen Ramsey. All those guys departed. Aaron Donald, and pretty much Matthew Stafford, Cooper Kupp were the only remaining pieces. And they didn't trade for those, but everybody they traded for were out of there, right? And they had to regroup. They had a team full of rookies a year ago. But somehow they managed to have a really solid season. They beat all expectations, and they played their butts off and did well a year ago when everyone counted them out. I mean, Jacksonville has to look at it and say, look, we have to shoot our shot and deal with it as we go forward, I believe. And if you have an opportunity to get someone like a Justin Jefferson to go along with your franchise quarterback, you know, my mind is made up. I say shoot your shot.
Yeah, I kind of agree with you on that one, by the way, although I think it might take more than what you're offering.
Well, right, I just don't know. I just look at last year's draft, and it was so bad, and it's still to be written, so it's not fair to say it's so bad. But so far, the returns have been so minimal that they could have drafted Harrison and traded the rest of the class for Justin Jefferson, and I'd feel better about this year's team than I do as it sits. So,
Fred, I have a question for you about offensive line, and the Jags have added Mitch Morse, which is exciting to play center. But Mitch Morse is an older guy, and he's had a history of concussions. And so my concern is, I feel like they haven't done enough there. I'm not suggesting take the 17 pick, but they still, to me, we still have to add to that offensive line. If Mitch Morse were to get dinged up, miss a couple games, we'd have the same exact offensive line we had last year, which by all accounts was not good enough. Is that a concern?
I think you can still get some really quality linemen, you know, in the second, third round, third, fourth round, those areas. And certainly I would not use my 17th pick in the first for an offensive lineman. Mitch, I think he's a We spoke on it before. Mm-hmm. I believe you were playing hooky at the time or something. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know. I don't know.
I'm a hooky guy.
But no, we spoke on it briefly, and I just love his veteran leadership. Mm-hmm. You know, the fact that he has some savvy to him. He has the experience that we need. A lot of times across the board on the offensive front, you have to be able to communicate, and I think he does that well. He's played with a Pro Bowl quarterback, All-Pro quarterback, and Josh Allen, obviously. I think he's ready for the moment more than anything. The concussion stuff, the injury stuff, I mean, I don't think it'll be a huge problem. What is it, a two-year deal, right? Is it
mm-hmm. a short yeah, deal? It's a short deal, yeah.
So I think they're going to take advantage of, you know, those two seasons, and hopefully it'll all pan out for the reasons they brought him in. But I like that he's a veteran guy. He's a leader. He's been a captain there in Buffalo. The communication part, he has that down pat. And he's a good player. So I believe they can get two really good years out of him. God forbid injury, right? And, you know, hopefully they'll be able to go back in the draft and try and find some pretty good linemen later on.
Another draft question for you. Freddie Taylor is our guest. In terms of shooting your shot, okay, if you let's say the Vikings say no on Justin Jefferson, and again, that probably is a pipe dream, but it's just one that we'd like to talk about. But there is opportunity to, like, you know, maybe you can trade up to 9 with the Chicago Bears and the Adunze kid from Washington, or you know, if somehow Neighbors isn't gone in the top 9. There's three guys that everybody loves: Harrison Jr., Neighbors, and Adunze. They all think those are top of the line, number one guys. Would we be interested, would you be interested in trading up for one of those guys and getting Trevor perhaps a true number one receiver, which then makes Christian Kirk even more effective, et cetera, et cetera?
I absolutely love Neighbors. Mm-hmm. I love Rome Adunze. Mm-hmm. We're going to drop an episode with Rome here shortly.
Okay, how was he to deal with?
He is an amazing, mm-hmm. such a bright kid who knows the game, loves to talk football.
Okay.
I think he would absolutely love to be in Jacksonville. I think Jacksonville as a community would love what the kid stands for. I mean, he's right in line with how Trevor, from a character person, mm-hmm. His family, his background, the hard work. His grandfather is like 70 plus years old or mm-hmm. something. And we were just talking about the hard work that his grandfather believes in. It was something like he wouldn't drive to work. He would only ride a bike to work for his health. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like his stock is amazing.
Okay.
Like, just his family is amazing. But overall, he's a wonderful talent. He gets it done. He knows how to take the top off the defense. He's a deep ball threat. He runs all of the routes. He can catch every pass you throw at him. So I think landing him, if we could move up, landing him would be, I won't say equivalent to a Justin Jefferson right mm-hmm. now, mm-hmm. because we've seen what Jettis is capable of. But I think this kid has a high, high, high ceiling, extreme potential. So moving up to get one of those guys, whether it's Neighbors or either Rome, mm-hmm. Adunze, mm-hmm. I like both of those. Okay. Marvin Harrison probably will be gone.
Yeah.
But I believe Rome is a good option to be right there still around 9, 10, 11 or something like that. So we'll see.
Pretty big kid, 6'3", pretty good size yep. on him when you met. Yeah.
And it'll cost you less. It'll cost you less for the trade itself, and he's going to cost you less under his contract. So, yeah, that would certainly make a lot of sense.
I'll say this, too, correct. About the kid, and I just saw this and looking at him. Back in September, in a year where he caught 81 balls for 1,400 yards, he recovered an onside kick. He suffered a broken rib and a punctured lung and played the whole season.
Who, Adunze did?
Yeah.
Yeah, I want that guy.
We got a little toughness there, Freddie.
When I tell you he's tough,
yeah,
he's smart.
Yeah,
he's a hard worker. He doesn't quit. I mean, I love the kid's game.
Okay,
just
good.
Watching there in Washington, and then actually meeting him in person and talking to him for, you know, an hour. He didn't want to leave.
Okay, good.
You know, and he's been that guy, and he actually he didn't leave at the combine. until he got the three cone drill correct, because the way he was training it, they kept saying he wasn't touching the line. Mm-hmm. So after he got done, he sat there on the field and he just kept doing it. He wouldn't leave, and he was just out there trying to perfect it. And that's the sort of player you want on your team, that he doesn't care about distractions. He's going to compete and stay until he gets the job done. And we had a beautiful conversation, and you would love his demeanor, his mindset. So I think it would be a good pick if you can get up there to make it happen.
Okay.
Fred, I saw your tweet immediately after the Texans went and got Stephon Diggs. We haven't talked to you since they made that move, but Diggs to the Texans, just your thought on that impact and the challenge that that creates within the division.
You know, the one thing we saw from Steph being up in Buffalo was that he had four amazing years with the Bills. He averaged over 100 receptions a season while there. One of three receivers in the history of the game to have four consecutive seasons with 100-plus receptions. We know he can get the job done. Now, another thing we saw from the outside is what seemed like an attitude or a conflict and some strife between him and his quarterback. You know, one week it's, I don't need Josh, and the other week it's, Josh doesn't need Steph. Like, what exactly was it? But on the outside looking in, you know you never get the real facts, right, unless you're in the building. My question is, after a couple games, and maybe if he's frustrated and is not getting the type of balls that he expects to get from the quarterback, will he ruin the young quarterback? You know, I hope he doesn't, because he had a monstrous rookie season, won rookie of the year, and hopefully they can find a way to play together, minus two games, you know, minus the AFC South game. But I think with that roster of receivers that they have, along with Schultz at tight end, I think they have a great roster. And then what they did on the defensive side, picking up Brian Robinson, you know, to go along with the stout defense they're returning from a year ago. The Texans, and I hate to say it, man, right now on paper at least,
yeah,
it seems that they have, well, even last year they won the division, but right now it just seems like they're a better team on paper, and they might be the favorite to win the AFC South.
Another reason why you got to go get Rome Odunze.
Well, that would be one. Fred, you said something interesting there in the course of talking about Stephon Diggs' impact, and hopefully he doesn't, paraphrasing, have a negative effect on C.J. Stroud or ruin him. Tell us practically how that looks. How does that happen in an NFL locker room? I mean, you see what I'm saying? Like, if he does, quote, have a negative effect, how does that play out? What does he bring that makes that a worry?
Well, I think what was brilliant on the Texans' behalf is they got rid of the last 3 years of his deal. So now this would make him on a one-year deal, mm-hmm, and he would become a free agent after this. If he's not playing well, they can always sit him down, take the hit, and, you know, just out of sight, out of mind, one of those things. If that sort of conflict is going on in the locker room, mm-hmm, hopefully he's going to get down there and try to be the best teammate, be the best player he can be, and avoid all of that stuff. When you're in a locker room as a veteran guy and you see another – you know, something going on between the quarterback and the receiver, typically someone like myself would go and have a talk with both of the guys and try and find a way to smooth it out, because it's just being competitive. It's just wanting to do the best you could do for the betterment of the team. So hopefully Steph will go in there with a renewed sense of urgency and a renewed attitude, and hopefully they can find a way to work well together, because they're going to be too brilliant to waste that level of talent, you know, with their own individualism. So you can't be an individual. You got to understand this is being done for the best betterment of the team, whether that's, you know, running a clear out or running an underneath route. Like, Steph has to just accept his role, whatever that's going to be, whether it's a decoy here, decoy there, mm-hmm, and hopefully they can manage to get wins by doing so. So they got to show strong leadership in the locker room this year.
Yeah. Hey, great stuff as always, Fred. We're moving closer to the draft. We're going to see what happens here in a couple weeks, and we'll go from there. But we appreciate you as always.
Man, I love being on with you guys, man. See you next Monday.
Awesome. Thank you, buddy. Awesome.
Ow, you did that on purpose. They got me again, Fred. We'll talk to you. Sounds like a torture session out there, bro. I only got three more. That's it. They've used up their three for this hour, Fred.
Let us know if you ever want to join in one of the bets, and you can spin the wheel, too.
Be
it
great.
Takes a little piece of your soul every time you lose, buddy.
A big piece.
There's been some really dark days for us.
The only wheel I'll be spinning is roulette in Vegas.
That's my guy. That's my guy right there. All right, thanks, Freddie.
We'll talk to you next Monday.
There he goes, the man, the myth, the legend. And a future Hall of Famer, Fred Taylor. That's it. That's three this hour, right? I got all three?
No, that was two.
Are you sure?
That's two.
No, he got me at the very beginning of the hour, and then he got me when Fred came on.
Did I get him at the very beginning?
Yeah, that's three. He got me at the beginning of the hour. He got me twice with Fred.
You're soft over there.
No, my dog keeping count.
No, I keep it count. I was just seeing what y'all were going to do. You try to give me an extra.
Oh, we're going to 9 o'clock anyway, so we'll be good.
Yeah, I wanted to be.
Hey. Let's do our new...
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Play-by-play sports just sounds better on radio. For high school, college, and pro sports play-by-play, turn on 1010XL.
At Hodges Mazda, we are proud of our solid reputation in the Jacksonville community. Lauren Brooks here. As your hometown Mazda dealer, our high customer service standards and our huge inventory of new and used cars provide our customers a consistently first-rate car buying experience. Our professional non-commissioned sales team puts your best interest first without exception. And every vehicle purchase from Hodges Mazda comes with 2 years free maintenance. Visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com and discover the Hodges Mazda difference.
Hey gang, Hicken here. Let's talk skin. Listen. I want to tell you about Beach's Dermatology, and I want to remind you guys to wear your sunscreen. This is right up all of our alleys, man. We live right here in Florida, and if you're an active parent and you're hanging at the fields, if you like to go boating, if you like to fish, you like to chill at the sandbar, gang, wear the sunscreen. If you're the one that decided for years, hey, it ain't cool, well, cancer ain't cool either. Listen, I've dealt with these guys at Beach's Dermatology. They take great care of me, man. They check you over and make sure you're good to go. So if you're grabbing the clubs for your tee time, you're gassing up the boat, you're grabbing the chairs for your kids' game, man, make sure you bring the screen. And if you have any concerns right now, I'm telling you who to go to. Go to my guys at Beaches Dermatology. Give them a call online at beachesdermatology.com.
Have you been dreaming of enhancing your living space with top-quality custom windows and doors? Well, now's the 30-day spring sale with Renewal by Anderson. Save $300 on every window, $825 on all patio doors. Plus, no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Renewal by Anderson, a better way to a better window. Visit rbafla.com.
License number CGC1527613.
If your ride is making strange noises, don't wait and make it worse. Come to Action Transmission on Merrill Road. My expert technicians can diagnose the problem and likely fix it fast. Experience the difference at Action Transmission on Merrill Road.
Instant Keys. You don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you. Call 904-722-1111.
Instant Keys saves the day if you've lost or broken keys. They can program new keys and remotes for nearly every make and model of vehicle at a fraction of the dealership cost. Fast, honest, and reliable locksmith service. Call Instant Keys, 722-1111.
Your cooling system isn't working. Maybe somebody showed up with a portable electronic device. Then they discussed with you what your options are. Maybe they gave you an estimate that seems like an awful lot of money. What's the smart thing to do? When the situation merits a second opinion, get a Mike Merritt opinion. Yes, the Mike Merritt Comfort Team shows up with hand tools. We've never been able to fix an air conditioning problem with a tablet. Mike Merritt has been the trusted name for more than 30 years because there's never any hocus pocus. The Merritt Team will walk you through the diagnostic steps up close and personal and show you exactly what you need. And the Mike Merritt price is likely to be far less because there's never an overtime charge, and the Merritt team doesn't work on commission. So remember, when it comes to the health of your cooling system, a second opinion can only help, and a Mike Merritt opinion can save you money. Florida license CACO 50384.
Hello.
Every great call comes to you on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
Just pick up your telephone and dial.
Listen for great phone interviews all day on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
We'll talk on the phone.
On 1010XL.
Are you 18 years or older, just got married, just got divorced, or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700, offices Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
We're in Florida, and pest problems are persistent. Want them gone? Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions. Veteran and locally owned and operated, Mission Pest will blow your mind with their communication and response time for all your pest, termite, and mosquito needs. Text or call 904-944-PEST. You'll speak directly with the owners. Mention 1010XL when you call 944-PEST. You'll get 25% off your initial pest or termite protection service. Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions.
Jimerson Burr is a full-service, Florida-based commercial law firm that has experience and capabilities to handle any legal issue a business is confronted with. Learn more about what they can do for you at JimersonFirm.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, boaters and landlubbers, friends, four-legged and two, this is Lisa the Boatinista with a huge announcement. Freedom Boat Club is opening a brand new fourth location. That's right. Freedom Boat Club St. Augustine Shipyard is now open. Now members can enjoy unlimited access at Julington Creek, Jacksonville Beach, St. Augustine Comanche Cove, and St. Augustine Shipyard. Freedom Boat Club members also enjoy reciprocal access to over 400 locations across the world. There's never been a better time to join. We are offering our biggest discount ever to celebrate our brand new location. We own and maintain an entire fleet of boats. Join the club, and as often as you like, you can do water sports, inshore fishing, offshore fishing, sandbar hopping, dining on the water, or just cruising around town. Visit us at the St. Augustine Shipyard or stop by any of our locations to see what the Boatsierge experience is all about. Visit us at freedomboatclub.com.
Now that's what I call high quality H2O.
If you want high quality water throughout your home, call your local water board. We install equipment to solve any water problem. WaterboyJAX.com.
Roland Reisch Plumbing, there when you need them. Big or small plumbing problem, call Roland Reisch Plumbing anytime at 260-7059. 260-7059, where quality and experience count.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
I absolutely love Neighbors. Mm-hmm. I love Rome Odunze. We're going to drop an episode with Rome here shortly. He is an amazing, such a bright kid who knows the game, loves to talk football. I think he would absolutely love to be in Jacksonville. I think Jacksonville as a community would love what the kid stands for. I mean, he's right in line with how Trevor, from a character person.
All right, 2 years. Rome Odunze, by the way, played all 4 years at Washington as a true freshman. Went to Bishop Gorman High School, where he was like one of the great players of the year. But what I loved is that he played a season with a broken rib and punctured lung from September. Played through it and had 81 catches, 1,428 yards, 13 touchdowns. Got better every year. A lot of good stuff about Rome Odunze. So we'll see if they can make something happen. But that would look like a guy that you definitely might be interested in if you're going forward. Something happened in college baseball this week that is beyond ridiculous and unacceptable and really embarrassing for the men in black, the boys. We had a play. Georgia and Mississippi State were playing SEC baseball. And it was 2-2, third inning, and base hit in the gap. Guy from first is whipping around, going to try to score. And so we got a plate to plate. The Mississippi State catcher blocks the plate, you know, gets the guy out, pushes his leg into the Georgia player, gets all in his face, screams and yells at him. He lost his marbles for a minute. That's okay. You're out of the game. It's done. But no, because they say, well, the bench is clear. I don't give a darn. We took 40 minutes, and we have 11 ejections. There should have been one ejection right away, catcher out, and we continue.
Yeah.
It's beyond ludicrous. Now we got to deal with suspensions and all this stupidity because and it's all because of the catcher. And I don't care if the catcher's emotional.
I don't even know why he was emotional. It wasn't even a dirty slide.
No, it wasn't.
That guy's got anger management.
He lost his mind.
Just a normal play. I'm with you. I thought it was weak.
First off, I don't like stopping a game for 40 minutes to review tape. Let's go. I saw what happened. Nobody else threw punches. Nobody else. How do you come up with 11 ejections? I guess it must be you left the dugout, whatever. But and so maybe it's not all their fault. Maybe that's the rule. But it's just stupid. And you got to get a hold of this stuff or you just there's I don't know. It's just ridiculous. And I don't like seeing it. I don't like seeing it. I'll tell you what else I don't like. And I've seen it at all levels now. And I think the worst thing ever, and I know I'm an old fuddy-duddy. I know him from old school baseball. But I'll be curious to remind me to ask Murph about this. I think when Bryce Harper came out with the let them play and all that nonsense, I'm fine with exciting. But it is filtered down. My son was hitting yesterday and I was over, you know, watching him hit, working out, and there was a youth game going on. These are 9, 10, 11-year-old kids. Okay. And I'm all for excitement. And I've seen video of this from middle school as well. Some of these celebrations at second base because you hit a double in youth baseball.
I know, man.
Is the most ridiculous junk I've ever seen.
I think we need to get – I'm going to say this
guys,
because –
do we have to really – can we act like we've been there?
What happened, Dave.
And
this
I'm not saying be Barry – I'm sorry. I'm not saying be Barry Sanders and hand him the football. No. You can celebrate a little. But, I mean, I got kids like – that, and it's not just – I don't mind at different levels. I don't mind – you know, like the team we played this week in junior college baseball would do a square and punch through it and they'd all go boom. That's kind of funny. I like that. You know, I don't mind that. But I got like fist pump, throwing around, coming back, doing a dance.
Whole handshakes. That's crazy.
Enough!
It's back to the theory. Dan, when we were kids, if a guy did that, you know what happened? He'd get punched in the dadgum face.
Yeah.
And the guy who punched him wouldn't be viewed as some crazy, violent bully. Yeah. He'd be like, yeah, he deserved it.
No.
But we don't do that anymore.
Yeah.
If a guy gets up and gets all in your face and flaunts it back in the day, you get your ass beat.
And then you'd stop being that guy.
There's no solution if they won't monitor it. Here's the deal. This is what I love about this. You should be able to. No, it's called sportsmanship, man. That's timeless.
Yeah.
That's not a boomer thing. That's not anything. That's called humility.
Yeah.
Be a good sport. Get a double. Stand there. You didn't just reinvent the wheel. You got a double in baseball. Whoopty freaking do, man.
Yeah. I know.
If you're a major leaguer and you got a double, big freaking deal.
And I'm talking about at all levels now because it filters down.
Not
so that's
for sure.
And it's I don't know. Like I said, I love the game. I love baseball. I love watching it. I just, golly, man. I mean, come on. This is what leads to catcher losing his mind over a simple play at home plate. I just don't get it. But anyway, it is what it is. I just happened to witness it. I'm like, enough's enough. I mean, what are we doing?
I'm on to the gig here. I'm on to the rhythm of what exactly happened.
Yoda sneaks in.
He sneaks in with the camera. Has ratcheted up another level on the shock collar here for the hour number three.
Yeah.
And so now I got to sit here all. Uh-huh. And now he wants me to think that, Knott's coming, but that's because he started rolling and then left. See?
Yeah.
See, now he's even asking me, is he ready?
I mean, I'm going to just go ahead and ask him if he's ready. Hold on. Let me get you right.
I think I'd rather not go.
Hold on, Jeff. Hold on. Since you know it's coming,
I'd rather not know.
Ah!
Ooh. Ooh, yeah, you upped it a couple. Yeah. Was that fake? Text line? You jackasses.
That's a fake out.
Yeah, was that fake? Yeah, that was fake. Hick, was that fake?
I know it ain't fake.
Did that look fake?
I know it ain't. I took it
jumped
on five.
Jumped out of my damn seat. A five? Yeah, yeah.
Took it up to five, did you?
Yeah, that's not fake. So.
Oh, snap, my bad.
He's on six?
No.
Oh, no. I got two left. So we'll do that in hour number whatever we're at.
And then to be fair, too, now remember – when we going to decide what I got to put on
tomorrow?
The
yeah,
we'll start that.
Yeah, and then we'll spin it on Wednesday. By Thursday or Friday, you're going to be in purgatory, my brother.
Right?
Ain't going to be good. I did that for the team.
By the way, Bill Barnwell has written an article about what every team should do as far as trading, and he says the Jaguars should trade up, and he's saying trade up and go get
an Odunze. Yeah,
which is kind of what everybody is saying. And again, I don't know if that's right or wrong. I'm just telling you that's what I would do. It's just time. It's time to try to give Trevor every chance he can to be victorious and try to win some football games and give him some help that he needs. So we shall see. The big story, a lot of big stories going on in the sports world. We'll come back in the 9 o'clock. We'll get nasty. But John Calipari going to Arkansas is really a stunner. And I'd be very curious to see what direction now. If you're Kentucky, can you go get T.J. Otzelberger from Iowa State?
No,
he's not a big
happening.
Enough boy,
no,
right?
No, you're getting one of those established, or you're getting Billy Donovan. I really believe that. I think Billy Donovan's in play more than like you do, and which is fine. I mean, it's not a competition here, mm-hmm. but mm-hmm. yeah, I think you're going for the biggest and best. You're trying to, first and foremost, can you get Jay Wright out of retirement?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the Villanova coaches. Can you get Bill Self to come from Kansas? I mean. Yeah. Roy went to North Carolina from Kansas. Now he was a North Carolina grad. That
the
matters.
Guy right now is Hurley. That's the guy you got to
for call. Sure.
You got to see if he's interested.
Well, and it's not just is he interested. Can UConn match the pay? No, they can't. Right. How important is the money?
And you call him at midnight tonight.
They may. I promise you, they've already talked to his agent.
Yeah, see if there's any interest at all.
I saw the most amazing quote that I have forgotten about from Danny Hurley in 2020.
Mm-hmm. And he better get us now.
Yeah, and he sat there, and you better get us now. That's all I'm saying. We're somebody else did that recently, and it's also proved true.
Deion said that, didn't he?
Deion said that. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, Deion, you're 3-10, so you still left to be said. But man, that what Hurley to say, and now be here. I don't want UConn to win simply because it's Florida.
Yeah.
You know, Florida's the last to win the back to back. You like to hold on to that bit of history as long as you can.
It'd be interesting if it'd be not. I mean, if Purdue does it, they did what Virginia did five years ago, and then you got to wonder, can that really spur
idea,
a team?
Idea to win the Natty, get a top seed next year, lose in the first round, and then you're guaranteed the next year. I don't think Purdue is beating UConn tonight, but I think they can.
Either.
That big man matchup. UConn and South Carolina women, there's a lot of parallels. The teams they're facing are really good, and they got elite talent, but they're so much deeper and bigger than their opponent. It's the same thing with UConn's men. They're just deeper, Dan. Alabama just couldn't keep answering. And it was the same with Caitlin and Iowa yesterday. They just couldn't keep answering. They run out of time and the other team extends. In this case, UConn and in yesterday's case, South Carolina. I will say this one, that South Carolina-Iowa game, big kudos. Thank you. It takes women's sports to give me my championships at 3 o'clock on a Sunday afternoon. I'm all for it.
Yeah,
I'm all
tonight.
For it.
9:20 tonight.
I watched more yesterday. I watched the whole game yesterday. I won't be able to tonight. Nope, because they got to go till midnight for some reason.
All right, 9 o'clock nasty coming up on The Drill.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Now, another classic moment in Jags history.
Now he's going to run. It's a try. He's across the five and into the end zone. Touchdown.
I'm Mark Brunell on 1010XL.
Home of the Jaguars.
Hey, Hickett here for George Moore Chevrolet. April is car care month. You know who knows that? George Moore Chevrolet. But you know what? Every month is car care month for George Moore Chevrolet. They want to help you get your car ready for the summertime and get that ride rejuvenated with an oil change, fresh set of wipers. And by the way, you take George Moore Chevrolet for a limited time only. They got a nice little offer, 10% off when you bundle your oil change and new wipers. Tell them Danny sent you. Their certified technicians are committed to delivering top-notch service, man. They use the highest quality products to keep your vehicle running smoothly and safely. I'm telling you, certified and technician, man. Their service advisor will take care of you at George Moore Chevrolet, and you can thank us later. Visit George Moore Chevrolet's award-winning service department today. George Moore Chevrolet, together! Let's ride.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them. Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
AgPro Sign and Drive event is offering 0% for 84 months with no money down on a John Deere compact utility tractor with loader. Limited time offer. Visit your local AgPro dealer today. Offer ends April 30th, 2024. Subject to approved credit. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Packer here with another unbelievable stat. I'm now down 45 pounds in just 6 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. 45 pounds, and I basically just started the program. I wasn't always this walking advertisement for feeling good. Let's just say the struggle was real. Tried everything, programs, diets, and yes, even those injections. Sure, I lost a few pounds, but the results were so slow. Top that with not feeling myself, coupled with needing shots for the rest of my life? No thanks. Thank you. It's not just the 45-pound number. Even though, yeah, that's unbelievable. It's about life, man. I took Little Hack to SeaWorld last week. Walked around all day, no sweat, no being tired. 2 months ago, I would have skipped out on that whole experience. If it's time for you to drop some weight like it was for me, do what I did. Go to awaken180weightloss.com or call 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800. It's Awaken 180 Weight Loss.
Clearwater.
John, I can't even mow my side yard. It's so soggy. Man, my builder sucks.
Brent, calm down. This is a common problem in neighborhoods where houses are built too close together. You need gutters and a properly installed French drain that will soak up subsurface water. We can completely dry it up.
So I can take my builder off my speed dial now, huh?
Yeah, we got you, buddy. Let that builder bitterness go.
Clearwater Irrigation.
And drainage, too.
Home of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
It's Googan Golf Time.
He's about 455 yards away.
Listen to the drill for your chance to play in this year's Coastal Equipment Googan Open.
April 15th at Hidden Hills Golf Club.
Grip it and rip it.
Score a hole-in-one, and you could win a zero-turn lawnmower from Coastal Equipment. Enjoy the Hidden Hills Googan Mule Cocktail and cigars from Tobacco Co. Breakfast from Chick-fil-A, and Dandy Foods has lunch covered. Win a Bernie Grill from Stone Core.
Thanks to our sponsors,
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists and 3D Digital.
Got a septic tank at your home or business? Give Duck Duck Rooter a call today to schedule your pump-out service. From septic pump-outs, inspections, to new septic tank and drain field installations, we are Northeast Florida's only master septic contractor. DuckDuckRooter.com.
If you owe the IRS and can't pay, now is the time to call J. David Tax Law. After a two-year hiatus, the IRS has resumed their aggressive collections letters. Don't wait. Call J. David Tax Law or visit jdavidtaxlaw.com.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update, sponsored by J. David Tax Law. Gator head coach Billy Napier, speaking after the team's spring scrimmage, highlighted the need for pass protection.
There's no question we needed to pass protect better. If you, anybody, even my wife would say that we could pass protect better last year.
The Noles have a number of transfers coming via the portal to the football team. Head coach Mike Norville talked about the adjustment.
You know, you try to adjust to the things you know, the language that you've learned, the techniques and fundamentals that are being asked, but now it's just getting caught up with the speed of the repetitions.
Florida State scored 5 runs in the 7th inning to defeat Boston College on Sunday afternoon. FSU improved to 26-5 and has won 3 of the last 4 ACC series on the season. Florida State returns home for rivalry week with games coming up against the Florida Gators and Miami Hurricanes. At your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update, I'm Sam Nelson.
At 9:13, it's 63 degrees. Your time and your temp is brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
All right, that's a drill speed trap alert in play, brought to you by Catlin Truck Accessories. Dames Point Bridge, both sides coming and going. Keep those, Ponch and John are out there this morning, so keep those speeds down. Keep that cash in your pocket. Keep the city streets safe here in the area with a drill speed trap alert brought to you by Catlin Truck Accessories. Radar detection and more there at Catlin. All right, I got today's pest of the day, man. I got a prediction for you. Mm-hmm. Diana Taurasi had her Curtis Strange moment this weekend. And boy, it must hurt. They get butt hurt, boy, when somebody comes along and gets more attention than they do, even though Diana Taurasi is a hell of a player. And I don't know how much better Caitlin Clark is than her. I just know she is a million times more relevant than Diana Taurasi ever was. Now, whatever those reasons
are. Listen, I'm all for... That was the UConn show who were they dead set against Iowa, and I get it. That's their school, but I mean, we got to have a little...
Well, she was on Scott Van Pelt's show. We got back from the Tebow thing. We watched the end of the game. I kept it on SportsCenter, which they overkill it, but whatever. So they're interviewing Diana Taurasi after the game, after Caitlin Clark has scored her 30 again and led to a win over UConn. And I hearken back to Curtis Strange sitting down with Tiger Woods, you know, and Tiger telling him second place sucks, and then him, you'll find out about that, kid, right? So they're asking Diana Taurasi and Sue Bird, they're asking her about Caitlin Clark and about her next step in the WNBA. And Taurasi had this to say: reality's coming. You look superhuman playing against some 18-year-olds, but you're going to come play with some grown women that have been playing professional basketball for a long time. You're going to have to give yourself some grace as a rookie. Some of that may be true. Caitlin Clark steps into the league a 1,000 times bigger entity than Diana Taurasi you'll ever be. So,
correct.
You know, that's all great and all that you have now. Caitlin Clark will beat your A right now. Okay?
Yeah.
She'll outshoot you right now. And so why not say it's great to have her come? Hopefully this will take our league to another level, because what's more likely to happen is your terrible, idiotic WNBA will tamp down Caitlin Clark's greatness. No one watches you goons playing in your darkened stadiums in front of 2,000 people. So to take a great player, a phenomenon, and tamp her down, bad business, Diana Taurasi. It's bad business. And you look so petty, little bizzle. That is the today's pest of the day, Diana Taurasi, for just let it breathe. She just had a great win, and you got to go with all reality's coming. Sure. Reality of what? Playing in front of 400,000 TV viewers instead of 14 million? That reality is coming, Diana.
I'll throw one more at
you. It's brought to you by Mission Pest Solutions, by the way.
And every fan base has these, but I saw it this weekend. It's really appalling, but I like the response from one of our guys. And I'm talking about the Mets. Obviously, I follow a lot of Mets social media, and Frankie Lindor is off to a slow start. I mean, slow, like 0-32, like one of the worst hitting streaks of his career. And yesterday, he had a homer and a double, so he basically tripled his amount of hits this year, or whatever. Anyway, a couple guys tweeted at his wife, and I mean the words and the vulgarity that they used were despicable. But it's not that okay. And she doesn't usually respond, but she responded, and everybody, of course, stuck up for her and him. And anyway, but one of our guys, one of our big Met fans, simply said this, and I think this is well said. I'm not going to highlight the tweet because it just fuels more negativity on this and other platforms. But there used to be at least an unwritten rule with internet trolls. It's still dumb, but talk all the crap you want to an athlete, person, place, thing, celebrity. That comes with the territory of being in the spotlight, and unfortunately, a lot of humans have diarrhea of the fingertips. But never drag innocent family members into your BS. That should go without saying. Wives, significant others, kids, etc. should be off limits. Be a D if that's what makes you get through the day. It's a weird way to live, but at least try to have a splinter of decency in your insecure life.
Well, they don't,
though.
Just doing that will just inspire them to be more, because some people take great glee in being the a-hole.
Yeah.
And I don't understand these people. I guess they don't
Diarrhea of the fingertips is well said.
That was a good one.
Yeah. Well said.
It's a medium I'm happy to be not involved with at all.
Yeah. It's. I mean, my gosh, dude. I mean.
People take stuff way too.
And again. You know, fans are like, oh, he's getting paid. I don't care. You don't say the things that were said to this lady, his wife, are just gross.
That doesn't surprise me at all, man.
Tough guy.
It doesn't surprise me. If you ever make your insults blindly behind a keyboard, you're a coward. And the odds are whoever it is you're threatening would laugh if your nerdy, weaselly, trolly self walked up to them, because you have not a lot going on in your life, right?
I just wanted to mention that. I couldn't
imagine just blindly attacking someone out of nothing. And listen to me. You know, we know, plenty of people can very easily get on my nerves. I don't need to go on Twitter and say their wife is this or that. That's just
That's soft, man.
I don't understand that. Yeah. I don't understand.
If I read them to you, you would be
whoa. I don't want you to.
I won't.
That's all those Sharks football. Let's fire up the hotline.
Let's bring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
All right, let's bring in our coach, head coach Jason Gibson, right now on the hotline. Home opener on Saturday. Did not go as hoped. Listen, man, that's sports, coach. You can reach the highest highs, win a title. You can reach what feels like the lowest lows. I'm guessing. I know your resume. I'm guessing three-game L streaks haven't appeared very much in your coaching career. And I mean, I'm not being facetious here or making light of it. I'm sure you're in a grindy little difficult stretch here. So how you holding up there, my man?
It's a first for me.
Yeah, I thought that might be true. I mean, so anytime you're encountering something for the first time, it can leave your head swimming a little bit. So you're trying to figure out a few things right now. How would you prioritize what's got to be figured out as quickly as possible?
You know what? You know, and I can only use this for one more week.
Yeah,
and it's really just got to get the right personnel for this type of game. Mm-hmm. It's different. It's different. And so we're working on that. And it'll, you know, it's the first quarter, it's a long season. But at some point, you got to turn the corner. So, like you said, I've never been in a I've never lost three games in a row. That's the first. But also, you know, we know how to win. Jacksonville knows how to win. I know how to win. And we'll get it fixed. It's just not as happened as fast as I wanted it to be.
What's been the biggest impediment, do you think, through the three games overall? Like, what is happening on the field that has you perplexed or flummoxed?
Just simple mistakes, simple discipline mistakes.
Right, right.
That's not me. So, you know, I'll take that on the chin. I'll take that. That's one that's not, you know, Sharks football. That's mm-hmm. not Jason Gibson football. I think that's what probably would bother me the most if I was to, you know, had to talk to the fans is, you know, trust me, nobody is taking it harder than me.
I think people know that. Yeah, we know that.
You know, and that's, you know, and I'm more upset at myself. And yeah, I don't care what anybody thinks, you know, but our fan base deserves wins, period. And they'll get them.
Yeah.
The ownership deserves wins.
And
they'll get them.
And when you say mistakes, too, that doesn't mean like you're like all like penalties or turnovers. That could be part of it. But like the inability to stop a certain play that they run two or three times on you, right? Those kinds of mistakes of not being.
It's really just mistakes all around.
Yeah.
You know, a guy missing on special teams or a guy not paying attention or, you know, a false start on fourth down. You know, just little stuff that adds up. And people say little things. None of them little things. They're all big things.
Mm-hmm. Are you guys confident? So, you're keeping them confident? That can't be easy.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's because it's such a long – again, it's so long.
Yeah.
It's so many games. And I've talked to multiple coaches in this league, and they all warned me. They all told me, you know, it's going to take 4, 5, 6 games. They said, you always just drive till week 6. Unfortunately, I don't want to wait till week 6. I'd like to do it week 2.
Sure, yeah.
But they've all suffered their headaches early, you know, joining this league. And unfortunately, I'm going through it. So, you know, the good thing about it is you go through it now, situational football, you learn from it. And you have it, you know, and you make the changes necessary to be made. You know, last year we were 2-2. We lost the Orlando game. You know, I got to tell you, I thought the world was going to end. I mean, you don't lose Orlando at home. But it forced me to make changes that I might not have made had we won that game. And then it changed the outcome of the season. So, you know, in this, you know, being 0-3 starting out, you know, against the teams we're going against, it's forcing me to make changes that I might not have made if we had snuck one of those games out. So now you make those changes for the better.
Well, it's not the gotten off to a tough schedule. That's a really good team that came in here this weekend. And they're, like you said, plenty of time to get things straightened out. And
right.
So I'm sure lots of confidence there. And we know how you're wearing it, Coach. And we'll be rooting for you this weekend. And we'll talk to you next Monday.
All right, guys.
All right, there he goes.
Thanks, bye.
Yeah, you bet. That's head coach Jason Gibson of your Jacksonville Sharks. And, yeah, it's an 0-3 start. And you heard him say, I kind of threw that out there. Not knowing but yeah, first three-game losing streak of his coaching career.
Oh.
I mean, that's how, that's how it's rare it is for them to struggle. I actually watched just a little bit of the UFL this weekend, and I looked at it through this prism. It's unwatchable because of where the players are playing. In other words, there aren't many sports other than the NBA that you will watch the city of Birmingham challenge the city of Detroit. You don't care. But I did think of it this way. The quality of the football is high enough that I do think that I think the mistake they're making is they shouldn't have teams in L.A. and New York and Chicago. They should put them all in the San Antonios and Birminghams and cities that don't necessarily have the NFL already. I wonder how popular it would be. I think it would be more popular here in Jacksonville than what I see on these television sets. And I've said this before about it, and I'm not selling you on this. I'm not selling you on the UFL. We've tried it. It just doesn't work. People have some football fatigue. I'm just saying that combining those two leagues and watching the games, I watched a little bit both days, especially yesterday at noon. There was nothing on yet, so I watched about almost the first half of a game. E.J. Perry, wasn't he in the Jags for a while?
Yeah, he was.
Right, he was a quarterback of one of the teams. It's not terrible football. I think it's up its, you know, its basement level is a little higher than it was. I think if Jacksonville had a team and didn't have an NFL team, I think we would be.
Oh, yeah.
I think it'd be more popular here.
Especially the way we support those our other teams. So, yeah.
The football wasn't bad, but I think unless you have a team, I don't know how watchable it is. I guess that's what I'm saying. I'm not here arguing that Jacksonville should have a team or that they would support it. I'm saying I think it would be more watchable, but then I watch these games, and this is such a rough implication for a sports league. But, man, the first thing you do is when you turn on a TV, when you turn on a game and there is no one in the stands, it immediately just screams at you, this is unimportant. Why are you watching this? Whether it's a Major League Baseball game in Oakland where there's 20 people there, or it's a tennis match, there's no one there, whatever. It just tells you, yeah, no. And so that, you know, I think that matters, man. When I turn on these games on the weekend and there's just, you know, you're looking in the lower levels and you don't see anyone there. But I that's probably it for my viewing. I switched on there for a couple minutes. Again, they're playing. If you can't succeed, man, I mean, there's not a lot of competition, is there?
Not at all.
I mean, if you
man.
Can't get your league to work when you got a game on Saturday night at 7 and Sunday at noon, there's not a whole lot else on. I mean,
right. We
know how segmented the popularity of Major League Baseball is, or college basketball in this case. And so I just. You know, I don't think there is a path to like super relevance for this league, but I do think that the level it's leveled up a little bit. It looked like a little bit better football to me. It looked more like what I'm watching on, you know, on NFL Sundays than when they had it split up between three or four other leagues.
Did you get to lock in on the kickoffs?
I never saw one, man. Yeah. I did. I caught right after it. Nothing's happening. There aren't these big excited. They're selling us is they want to bring the kickoff play back. Like, that's what the NFL sell is. We're bringing the kicker, you know, there hadn't been enough returns. But when I watch how it's set up there, it's like a slow move. Oh.
We're down to one?
Gave a little extra there.
Nah, it's still on four.
No, but you gave it a little long something. There was something different about that one.
Yeah, I ain't going to do you like that, bro.
Something happened different.
It's still on the same.
Could have been accidental. I don't know.
I'd admit to
something happened.
Is there one left or is that it?
No, I got one more.
Yeah, there's one left.
One more shock and awe?
He's right now trying to protect his wheel tomorrow. That was worse. He's now.
Do I have to take over for the last 20?
You can if you want.
He's taken our friendship down a path of dishonesty.
Hey, Unc, I'd never do that, Unc.
He's coming for you.
Man, I got one more. I wish I didn't. This is the drill. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback, divorcemenonly.com.
The Florida Gators are on 1010XL.
The rivalry returns to the Diamond. Florida State Baseball. Tomorrow night at 6 on 1010 AM.
The Drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
Hicken here for Lockhart Construction. They're a longtime Jacksonville business. Shane's dad started the company. Shane, his guys are from here, taking care of people who live here, people like me. Man, we need a new bathroom, and man, we call Lockhart Construction and lickety-split, man. Fast, friendly, affordable, clean. They got that remodeling done, no problem. Shoot, They'll do anything for you. No job too big or too small. If you need something done, give the Lockhart family a call. Their family gives your family a better living experience. I like to say you unlock better living with Lockhart Construction. Construction need, thought, idea, give Shane a call. He'll call you right back, 994-3865. Shane Lockhart, Lockhart Construction, 994-3865.
It's March basketball. That means a host of top teams will be competing for the NCAA title. When it comes to commercial painters, there's also some healthy competition out there. Jason Parker with Performance Painting. To help you know the right questions to ask any painter competing for your business this year, visit PerformancePaintingJax.com. Or if you're ready for a friendly quote, give us a call and ask about our free pressure wash promotion for your next project. Performance Painting, quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
Have you been dreaming of enhancing your living space with top quality custom windows and doors? Well, now's the 30-day spring sale with Renewal by Anderson. Save $300 on every window, $825 on all patio doors. Plus, no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Renewal by Anderson, a better way to a better window. Visit rbafla.com.
License number CGC1527613.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit republicservices.com.
Equal opportunity employer.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit UA234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
When you step into a courtroom, you're stepping into a fight. Someone wins, someone loses. I'm attorney Brett Hastings, and at Hastings Injury Law, we've got the experience you want in your corner if you or a loved one suffer a personal injury or a wrongful death. We're here to fight for you. So if you get hit, hit back with Hastings Injury Law, offices Jacksonville. Find us on the web at 904hitback.com or call our 24-hour helpline, 904-HITBACK.
The flagship station of the Jacksonville Jaguars, 1010 XL, 92.5 FM.
Well, I'd like to think that you know this already, and I sure hope you have experienced it if you're a pet owner. Because if you're a pet owner, there is only one place that gets you the peace of mind that you want, and it's a perfect name. It's Pet Paradise. It's the ultimate home away from home for your four-leg family member. Whether your pet prefers a splash in the pool or just making new friends, Pet Paradise's team of pet lovers now, pet loving pros, going to ensure the most important pet in your world has a great visit, whether it's day camp or an overnight stay. Oh, by the way, inside these ultra modern facilities, dotting the First Coast, I believe 8 or 9 locations now, it's always any and everything you need under one roof. They have professional grooming services, veterinary services with New Day Veterinary Care. At Pet Paradise, it's top shelf customer service and treatment for that member of your family, that four-legged member of your family. So go to Pet Paradise right now. Book an appointment. Find out what they're all about at petparadise.com.
Hold on tight, because All Pro Roofing is unleashing some electrifying news. Brace yourselves for instant excitement. Instant roof quotes are here. Simply surf over to their website and hit the Instant Roof Quote tab. Boom. That's your ticket to a lightning-fast estimate. Head over to allproroofingllc.com. Click that Instant Roof Quote tab. What are you waiting for? Click on the Instant Roof Quote tab today at allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC1327056.
CDC0601038.
Slacker Plumbing.
Yeah, hey, listen, I need a plumber over here right now.
Yeah, well, we don't have any openings for about 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yep.
I was just changing the shower head, and the water line broke, and it's flying everywhere.
All right, 1 week.
What if I throw you an extra $100 to come now?
What's the address?
It's 201.
Huh? I guess he changed his mind.
If you've got a leak that can't wait a week, call Roland Reese Plumbing and fix your plumbing problems fast. PlumbingJacksonville.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
All right, we're back. Couple things. One, WrestleMania last night. Huge success. Two nights, 72,000 both nights.
Yeah, they've been doing that for a while, haven't they?
Two nights?
No, no, I mean the numbers.
Yeah.
I think it has been more than a night before. It seems like Hacker, when he used to go, it was more than... But I don't know that for sure.
Yeah,
I don't want to speak out of place.
I think they just went to two nights, but I'm not positive. Yeah. I'm not a WrestleMania expert, but apparently well-received. It's back. A lot of the wrestlers are back.
The second time it's been two nights.
Second time, okay.
Was the other time like 10 years ago or something? That they did two nights, or was last year two nights?
Last year, Yoda
loves that wrestling.
I saw this. I was shocked. I mean.
Yoda, did you do WrestleMania? Did you watch it? Come here.
He said it was the best.
Sit right here real quick.
Well, they had, like, I tell you this. You know, you get The Rock.
Yeah.
You know what The Rock does not need anymore in his life? WWE. Yeah, he don't need it one bit.
I was surprised that he was even there.
What were some of the highlights real quick?
The first night was The Rock, Roman Reigns versus Seth Rollins and Cody Rhodes.
Mm-hmm.
So it determined night two. So basically, if Roman and The Rock win, then night two is under their rules.
Okay.
And then if Cody and Seth won... then it's just a normal.
What guest appearances were made by celebs or wrestlers?
Snoop Dogg was there.
Okay.
Snoop Dogg showed up.
Was he involved in the script or no?
In night two, he was.
Okay.
He showed up in night two.
Okay.
Meek Mill was in the stands.
Mm-hmm.
Two Changes in the stands.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I don't know if
it was in Philly, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know if y'all know who I Show Speed is.
Oh gosh, yes. Yeah. I Show Speed.
Okay. Yes.
Legend.
So he was in the Prime bottle.
Yeah.
And then he took the face off and then got RKO'd.
Oh, he was in the Prime bottle, pulled the dude out of the ring.
Yeah, Logan Paul.
Logan Paul was there.
But
sure he was. He's the Prime guy, you know, Logan Paul.
But the final fight.
Prime is his drink, is it not?
The final fight yesterday was probably the best thing I've ever watched.
And who was that?
You know it's fake, right?
Yeah, I know it's fake. But it's about the nostalgic. Yeah. So Cody Rhodes versus Roman Reigns. Mm-hmm. And so it was under Roman Reigns' rules because he won the night before.
Mm-hmm. Every time we do this, I feel like it's CNN commenting on a Law & Order episode.
No, it's good, though.
You see what I'm saying?
No, but it got so good. And so one of Roman Reigns' cousins came out, started, like, tag-teaming on Cody.
Did they call him Cuz?
They call him, I think it's like Oos, something like that.
What up, Oos?
And then John Cena came out. That was
Cena's
great.
Big.
John Cena!
And then started fighting him. And then... Dwayne came out, The Rock, and then
on night two he made a second appearance.
Then Rock Bottom, John Cena, and then The Undertaker came out.
Cena and Rock fought each other.
The Undertaker came out.
The Undertaker too?
Yeah.
He's back too.
Huge night.
Is The Undertaker the one who's a mayor now in like Knoxville or something?
Is he?
Like one of those dudes. It's either The Undertaker or
I'll tell you what's gonna happen, and you can comment on this, Yoda, because you're an expert.
One of those dudes.
Our boy Tony Khan's gonna start investing a little more money because
the
momentum has shifted back.
The WWE's on top now for
sure. WWE is taking it back from.
I don't know if he ever completely caught him, but
he didn't.
Yeah.
But
it helped.
The AEW was like starting like
they were
catching
coming.
Fire.
Yeah,
for
they
sure.
you
yeah.
know it helped them working through COVID when the other ones weren't doing anything yet. I think.
But also after Vince McMahon like kind of like had his little allegations, Triple H, he like. Turned WWE back on top. That was crazy.
Right. Yeah, Jeff, apparently it's Kane who is the mayor.
Thank you for the report, Yoda.
Kane's a mayor, yeah. Dude's a mayor.
My dog in tune.
Yeah.
One other note, bad boy Morgan Wallen.
That's trending. Okay. Yeah.
He's grinning in a mugshot. Let's do trending right now.
All right, well, before you do that, I want to say this. Did you see this? All right, go ahead and start it. I got one. I got some trending for you.
Yeah, hold on.
I'll start with number five.
That's good. Hold on, let me get you right.
Number five.
That's right.
I just want to know, like, is he fighting Jake Paul, Mike Tyson, or Logan Paul? It's Jake Paul, isn't it?
One of them Pauls.
I want to know what the price tag is. Like,
me too.
Like how much is he paying Tyson to lose to him? Because I saw the Tyson workout video, and Mike Tyson is going to kill that boy.
I've been telling
people. He will kill him so fast. If Jake Paul, you can know when the introductions, if Jake Paul has paid him off. Because Jake Paul, if he hasn't paid him off, is going to pee himself.
I'm telling you, that old man still got it, man.
I saw the most recent training video.
Yeah.
And that's all it will take. All it will take is that 12-second burst.
I got to go
see
it. And
Jake Paul is going to be in night-night land, maybe for longer than an evening. He will totally and completely beat Jake Paul's butt like an ornery little 7-year-old unless he's paying him off. So I just want to know, how much was the price? Like, how much is he paying Tyson to take a dive? Because if any former great would take a dive for cash, it's Tyson, no? Like, you could see him doing, like,
him
you wouldn't
Lawrence
see
Taylor.
Tiger taking a dive and losing just to some YouTube golfer. You wouldn't see Tyson will take a dive if the millions is right.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what that is, if it's 10 million, 20 million, 30 million. But if Mike Tyson got in a ring with that boy and had a fight, he would beat the crap out of him really quick. And he looks, man, I don't care if he's 56, 57. He looks not like the 57-year-old that ran the 10-minute mile.
I'm watching the video right now.
Dude, it's
ain't
quick.
No way.
Yeah.
That
and he turned to the camera and says, you want them, bitch?
No.
Anyway, so Morgan Wallen in Nashville.
Hold on, let me get you right, Dan.
All right, thank you, friend.
Let me get you right.
Number 4.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's arrested. 3 felony counts.
Dang, bad boy
at
Morgan.
At a rooftop bar in Nashville, the Wasted on You appropriately hitmaker taken into custody, threw a chair from the 6-4 Chiefs bar in downtown Nashville about 11 o'clock last night. Officers from the Metropolitan Nashville Police Department claimed the chair landed 3 feet away from them. That's a bad throw, you know. Don't throw it around the police.
Okay, this guy, he had his get out of jail free already.
Yeah.
Right? He made a terrible faux pas, social mistake. I don't know what glimpse it is into him or not. What an idiot. What an idiot to come back from that, which he did, and bring this into your...
His problem is he's got a little drinking situation.
Well, Morgan Wallen is the country singer, the one who's the most popular country singer in on the planet right now. He just produces number one after number one, but he's the one that got caught with the using the N-word, like in a friendly way.
Okay.
You know, it wasn't like but whatever. You can't use it in any way at all.
That just goes to show you, I forgot about it.
Right, you did.
So he climbed out of it.
Well, because he used it, it wasn't in like a... Like, if you use that in a heated, insulting way,
you're using
that as an insult.
Because context matters.
It matters.
It does.
It matters.
Take it away.
You still ain't supposed to say it, but yeah.
No.
Number 3.
Let's see. Apple. So, Jeff, you won't be affected by this because obviously you're a Droid user. You're lower to the superior Apple users. At least all Apple users.
Yeah, I mean, again, just go to there's many Android as there is Apple.
If not more.
Yeah. That always surprises. Every time we look it up, it ends up being at least 50-50.
Well, they're launching a new iOS system, which is supposed to be the newest, latest, and greatest.
Yeah, they do that every 6 months, you Apple sheep.
But here's the thing. This is what caught my eye. They're adding, because AI is becoming a big thing. And apps are being, they're more friendly to AI. So a lot of the apps are friendly. So we'll see how this is going to work, man. Soon, these phones are going to just, like, we're already dumb enough because we got these super smartphones.
Mm-hmm,
so we'll see what these phones end up becoming. It's crazy.
Number two.
Congrats to South Carolina. The Lady Gamecocks won the national championship. Dawn Staley has now 3 national championships. As I said earlier this morning, a lot of people may not remember, but her whole team, all 5 of her starters from last year are gone.
Right.
So she went undefeated with a brand new starting five.
The 6'7 girl wasn't a starter?
Nope. All 5 of her starters. Got 5 new starters, and they ran the table, man. And much deserved, much credit, much props to Dawn Staley and the South Carolina Gamecocks for overtaking somebody who's perhaps bigger than the game right now.
The phenomenon. We just watched Tiger, LeBron. You know, we just watched that, and it just set up perfectly for the dramas. Like we said, this is a tremendous opportunity for women's sports and women's basketball if it could play out by form, and it did. You got Caitlin Clark in the rematch against LSU and Angel Reese, then you got her against the all-time behemoth in UConn and Paige Beckers, and then you got her against the undefeated team, and yeah, that's just a... You know, they set the all-time women's record for TV ratings in the Friday night semifinal. It'll be interesting to see what yesterday afternoon's pulled in. By the way, the rules are different for Tyson, I guess. He's got to wear heavier gloves, and he has other rules.
I still don't want him.
That's weak, though. That's weak. That makes Jake Paul's an even bigger puss than he was.
Number one.
And the number one trending topic. As of April 1st, 2024, I celebrated 2 years on the drill.
Yeah.
But come tomorrow, it's really official.
Yes.
When I get dubbed in as... when I get dubbed into the brotherhood as
the
your
brotherhood.
Boy.
Initiation.
The initiation as mm-hmm. Unk them will pick my fate and I spin the wheel.
Yes, we will. Mm. Yes, we will. It will happen tomorrow. And yeah, it's a tough one. It's tough. Of course, also the eclipse is coming up today,
oh, yeah.
Right?
Don't forget the eclipse.
Yeah, don't forget the
eclipse. I don't know what time it is, but yeah, that's what's happening today.
Let me tell you, I think here it's between 1 and 3.
It's not a full eclipse here, however.
No, and you can't look at it. So, like, what's up? Like, what are you supposed to do? You got to, by the way, beware of the dude standing on the corner selling you glasses that aren't at all equipped to handle the. I mean, you got guys going to the dollar store and buying 50 pairs of glasses, then turning around and selling them for $10 at the corner of San Jose and Mandarin Road, right? So, just, you know, if you are going to try and look at it and you're going to use the special glasses, make sure you really do have the special glasses. But, I mean, what are you supposed to do? You're not allowed to look at it unless you have those glasses. You don't have the glasses, do you, Hick?
No.
Are you going to watch the eclipse at all?
Yeah, I'm going to look right up at it. No.
I'm going to watch it on TV. That's what
right.
I'll do.
It'll be all over social media tomorrow.
Right. I'll just put it on TV and see it. I find it much more fascinating to get up at 5:30 in the morning once a month and watch the rocket take off from Canaveral. You can see that from here, too.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. That's what's trending. Well done.
Brought to you by Pet Paradise. We'll put a wrap on it when we return. It's been the Monday Morning Quarterback, DivorceMenOnly.com.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Go inside your home team's locker room with Jags beat reporter Hayes Carline.
Check out my blog at 1010XL.com.
So you can catch all the news and nuggets you need to know.
My blog is brought to you by Wolin Reese Plumbing.
Where quality and experience count.
Is your AC system showing signs of wear and tear? Get ahead of your AC system replacement before the summer with JTM Comfort Services. Nothing worse than coming home on a hot summer afternoon to find your AC stopped working. Right now, get a special rebate on the purchase and installation of an 18 to 20 SEER Bosch heat pump system. Financing now available on qualified repairs and replacements.
Your comfort is our name. Call my dad to keep you in the game.
Yo, it's your boy E.T. And if you're still in the market for a sportsbook to call home, bet that nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is your one stop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with real-life Vegas experience right from that cellular device of yours. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the comfort of the crib. Sign up now and take advantage of the generous welcome bonus on your first deposit, all the way up to $1,000. Put in 200, get three. Ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun don't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you dictate where to put that cash at. And the best part about MyBookie, you can bet anything, anytime, anywhere with MyBookie. Come on, somebody.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement. Plus, no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
Are you looking for quality tires that won't break the bank? Well, Big Chief Tire has you covered. Frank Rangie here. Get $50 off a new set of tires, and for even greater savings, finance with a CFNA card to receive an additional $50 off your first purchase and no interest for 6 months. Schedule an appointment today at BigChiefTire.com or call 904-932-0950 and take advantage of these incredible deals. Big Chief Tire keeps jacks rolling.
DivorceMenOnly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to DivorceMenOnly.com. DivorceMenOnly.com. offices, Jacksonville.
This State in Sports History is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 8, 2001, in the 65th U.S. Masters Tournament, Tiger Woods wins his second Masters and sixth major title, two strokes ahead of David Duval.
I'm here with Clayton Bromberg of Underwoods. Clayton, let's talk about diamond cutting. How is a diamond price affected by the way it is cut?
Frank, that's probably the most important question asked about diamonds, because the trade-off between a diamond cut for maximum beauty and one that's not is the diamond's carat weight. You see, diamond cutters buy rough diamonds based on quality and weight. So as they cut the rough diamond, everything cut away affects profits. However, there are specific known cutting parameters, and each deviation from these means they have a heavier, less beautiful diamond. Unfortunately, a customer can't detect all those cutting imperfections. They need expert help about a diamond's cut grade. You see, for any round diamond of a particular color, clarity, and carat weight, there are as many as 10 different prices that can vary by as much as 50%. At Underwoods, we look specifically at how a diamond's cut before we look at anything else, because it's the most important factor when it comes to a diamond's beauty, and to us, whether it should carry the Underwood name or not.
15,000 workers. I'm Brian Rose from Remedy Staffing. We survey 15,000 blue-collar workers each year to better understand what drives quality and dependability in our workforce. The survey shows when looking for a new job, the initial pay rate, job security, and safety while working are the most important factors for hourly workers. If you're an employer and would like to learn more about the voice of the blue-collar worker, please call us at 904-528-1933.
The 2024 draft is almost here.
The Jaguars are now on the clock.
Join us at Everbank Stadium Thursday, April 25th for the official Duval draft party presented by Donovan Air Electric and Plumbing. Be there as the Jaguars make the 17th overall pick, and don't miss the unveiling of the official 30th season logo that you voted on. We're getting the party started at 7 p.m. Tickets are free, so register today at jaguars.com/draft party. We can't wait to see you there.
The Jacksonville Jaguars select...
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Apparently the route we need to go here for the eclipse is just look at the shadows on the ground. You're going to see like a thousands of crescents and shapes and whatnot.
Hey!
I don't like this down to the wire here, man. It's this thing over with. I know it's looming.
All right, you want it right now?
No, I just, no.
Give it to him.
No, I mean.
I don't like no.
Give it to him.
I almost like.
Big shocker.
I don't want
to watch. All right, then I ain't going to give it to you.
Just wait.
I like not knowing, to be honest with you. Like, when you're, like, waiting on it to come, it's worse. Ah, you son of a so-and-so.
That's it.
Take this thing off. I got my 9 shocks in. I paid off my debt to the Wheel Society. It's Society of the Wheel, Dan.
Yeah.
It's a whole different, it's a different society.
Takes a little bit of your soul every time.
Yeah, I took a little bit of my leg today. Both legs feel like they're sunburned. I don't know if that's just, I don't know, some sort of nerve reaction or whatnot, but yeah.
Shock Monday.
Yeah, shock the monkey. Hashtag shock the monkey is what they did today. They shocked the monkey, the show monkey.
Yep.
So yeah, anyway, there's that. You know, we haven't really talked a lick about the game tonight. It's just
I kind of like the fact that Edie and Klingon will be seeing each other eye to eye.
We haven't had a big man matchup. I was trying to remember. It's the last time two dominant big men hooked up. That's old school hoops, man.
Old school.
Like, you go to the NBA, the big men play at the 3-point line.
Mm-hmm.
They don't play it like these two do.
Yeah.
Now Klingon will come out a little bit more than, but Edie is like
all big
1950s. He stands on that low block,
that block
and he don't leave.
Back to the goal.
And he hasn't had a bunch of guys clinging size that can just stand there with him. Like,
no.
Edie was like that tall girl for South Carolina.
I think
he could just stand there and rebound over.
I think
you
know, that's what's going to hurt Purdue, because Edie's their guy, and I don't know that Edie can go for 35 and 15 tonight.
I know. I don't. They're going to have to, you know, Lance
I
Jones.
I would just say this.
And Lawyer.
I would please
Smith,
ask.
Those guys got to hit.
These officials. To not ticky-tack either one of those guys
play
early and
yeah
give them two fouls where 5 minutes in where they got to sit out a half.
Good point.
Let these guys – tell them before the game, whatever, but let them play basketball. Now, if it's a blatant, you know, slam on the guy's arm or hack, okay, it's one thing. But do not call this junk that will – let these guys play. That's what we – you know, this is what we're getting to see tonight. We're getting the clash of two big men who
two
are
best
gifted
teams, yeah, two great players.
Let them play.
two great programs, yeah, especially UConn. I mean, UConn hadn't got its deserve. You know, we talk about Duke and Carolina, Kentucky. They're all running second. UConn's won five in the last 30 years. They're going to win six tonight.
Best program going right now.
They are. They are. And, boy, no matter the coach, that's amazing, too, what they do there. What a culture they must have. So, all right, championship game tonight. We'll review and reflect on that and more when we come at you at a Tuesday. Also, brunch with the tour tomorrow. It's Masters Week. We haven't gotten into a bunch of that. There's
signature event.
Yeah, plenty of that coming up over the course of this coming week as well. It's going to do it for the Monday Morning Quarterback, DivorceMenOnly.com. Enjoy your Monday. We'll see you tomorrow.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the